Next is one of the free Operation Rainfall games and the one the least amount of people played, it's Pandora's Tower. We start viewing an extravagant harvest festival where our female lead Elena is singing. In the audience is the main character, Aaron, hiding beneath a hood. During the show, a strange mark appears on Elena's back and there's an explosion. Aaron charges towards it while a dark aura is seen behind the smoke. We next see Aaron taking Elena away while being chased by soldiers. They're signalled aside by an old woman, telling them to follow her. Cut to the countryside where Aaron and Elena have been following the old woman. While they sleep, the old woman tells Aaron that if he doesn't act to help Elena, she won't be human much longer, she'll become a beast. After seeing Elena struggling asleep, we see them some time later. Elena is hiding beneath a robe and struggling to keep up. Eventually they reach their destination. The old woman points out the 13 towers, a huge building suspended in the air above a chasm by some giant chains. Elena trips and loses her robe, revealing the extent of her curse. The old woman takes him to the observatory nearby. She also gives Aaron a weapon called the Araklos chain, saying he needs it to collect beast flesh for a ceremony to restore Elena's old self. Elena tells Mavda, the old woman, that she wants to go along, but Aaron tells her he'll be back. He jumps onto a chain and runs along it to the treetop tower. First thing I see is a statue holding a glowing chain. The statue is referred to as a god of Ios and has a symbol of wood. The way left is collapsed, so the only option is right. I can smash open chests and boxes for items. Here I just get 5 Lios, which is the currency in this world. I go through the first door I find on the right, in here I get more money and a dryad berry off the ground before going through the next door. A giant hornet appears only to get ambushed and smashed by our first enemy. These nether actually named, just referred to as beasts. Here the game explains battle. I can block and dodge and hit. I have a standard combo with my sword or I can hold the button to charge up a strong attack. When an enemy dies it flashes red. I then aim the Araklos chain at its body using the Wii remote or right stick if you're using the classic controller like me. It will latch onto the enemy's body and let me pull an item out, which in this case is beast flesh. It's still pulsating. Aaron decides it's time to go back. Back at the observatory, I enter and hand over the flesh. Mavda holds it out to Elena to eat. Elena is horrified. Mavda reasons it's because people who practice the religion of Ios like Elena are forbidden from eating meat. I think it's because it's giant, purple, slimy, raw and pulsating, but that's just me. I mean, I eat meat and I wouldn't touch that. Elena almost vomits but Mavda pushes her to eat it. If she doesn't eat it, the curse will progress and she will fully become a beast with no chance of being cured. Elena gives in and forces herself to eat it, trying not to gag the entire time. Elena doubles over in pain as the curse reverses and slowly returns to her human form before passing out. We then get some information on this world.
In the heart of the continent of Imperia lies the kingdom of Illyria. At its remotest edge, hundreds of leagues from the capital of Helicon, a forbidding wasteland stretches to the furthest horizon, Orcanus. Deep within this desolate expanse where none may set foot, the earth has been torn asunder to form a rift extending over thousands of leagues, known simply as the Scar. At its center, suspended above this fathomless fissure, are the 13 towers. Towers of all sizes, interlink and intertwine, each playing their part in the intricate design, fusing to become one single vast fortress. Held in place by 12 chains that grip the walls of the surrounding cliffs, the towers loom like a spider in its web, seeming to inhabit a space beyond the normal world. The bristling turrets of the towers serve a purpose. They bind the earth together, preventing the scar from widening and tearing the world itself apart.
Elena wakes up the next morning, relieved to be back to normal. She thinks she's safe to go home now, but Mavda dashes those hopes, saying the curse has just been reversed a little, not lifted. As long as the mark on her back remains, she will stay cursed. Mavda lets me know that Elena isn't the first to be cursed, many have been taken by it before. Some were found by the Illyrian army and killed, others just became beasts. Mavda herself is of the Vestra, a race of travelling merchants. The decrepit old man stuck in a pot on her back is her husband, but only she can understand him. Beast flesh can only put off the curse. What Elena needs is to eat flesh from each of the 12 masters of the towers. Elena can't bear the idea that Aaron will have to put himself at risk for her sake, but it has to be done. Outside, Mavda tells Aaron that the Araklos chain belongs to her people. She takes some of Elena's hair and fuses it with the chain. It ends up enveloped in a golden glow, binding the destinies of Aaron and Elena. The next morning, I wake up and talk to Elena. Talking to her raises affinity, represented by the gold glow on the left of the screen. There are 10 levels of affinity, and you reach the next one when the glow reaches the next gold dot. This influences the ending, but I'm going for the worst ending first, which means neglecting poor Elena. I then go speak to Mavda. She tells Aaron to make himself at home and reminds him that the army is still after him. The Illyrian army used to use the observatory to watch over the towers. I can buy items from her, forge items with material collected in the towers, or use those same materials to upgrade my weapons, or I can just talk to her for little bits of lore. She also tells me that any leftover flesh I have she'll buy off me. No reason not to, because it will go off and there's nothing else to do with it. She also gives me my first file, a news report on the incident at the Harvest Festival. I save by writing in Aaron's journal and check out the rest of the house. I can go upstairs to the roof or downstairs into the cellar. Down there I find a lamp to give to Elena. I find the file restoring the chain. It says the chain's power can grow and isn't what it used to be. Next to the desk where I save is the trunk. I put the lamp in there for now so I don't raise affinity. I leave and run to the chain to set off back to the treetop tower. There is a round gauge that measures Elena's curse progress. It stays still in the observatory but empties in towers. It refills when she eats flesh. When the gauge starts to empty to the blue sections, she will start to transform again. Back in the first room on the right I meet a new enemy. Also unnamed, these small beasts just take a few hits to kill. You don't get flesh from killing these, just money and a couple other items. In the next room I fight another of the beasts I killed earlier and blind it by shooting the chains to wrap around its eyes. I also trip it by aiming at its feet. When it's dead I get more flesh from it. I also get a lump of metal from one of the boxes. I'll only bring up a random item in the box the first time I find it from now on. I move into the next room where I kill a couple hornets. I find the file Treetop in Bloom. It's from the perspective of someone discovering the things in this tower that we're about to see soon. At the other end of this room, I cut the wood keeping this door leading to the entrance shut. I then get on this lift and hit the switch to set it off. Up here are a couple little beasts and a plant shooting seeds at me. One pull of the chain kills it and gets me some strange grains. One of the little beasts damages my dryad berry when hitting me. Any item aside from no weapons can be damaged and require paying Mavda to repair. After killing them I get nymph water from one of them. I then go through the door. More hornets in this room. I get my first bodily fluid from one. In the corner is the file Treetop Wasp Study about their nests. I go through the next door where the camera points out a glowing item across a gap I can't cross. But I can grab it with the chain. This is the warrior amulet. Equipping it increases my maximum health. In the next room I just drop down a little and climb to the next door. In this room is a honeycomb, a hornet's nest. It can spawn more hornets. After killing the hornets already there, I get to work destroying each segment of the honeycomb with charged attacks. When charging, if I let go of attack just as the blue ring closes on me, I perform a stronger attack. Once it's dead, I pull a dripping flesh from it. Dripping flesh restores more of Elena's curse gauge than regular beast flesh. On the other side of the room there's a red door I can't open and won't be opening for a long while, so I go through the door in the middle. This door leads to the giant upside down tree that has been growing from the top of the tower. I head up the stairs taking out the enemies on the way. I reach level 2 from the first hornet I kill. At the top of the stairs I pass the door and pick up a witcher's wand before going through it. In this room there's a fountain that restores health by drinking from it. I go through the next door. There are now strange ferns growing on the walls in this room. I get a medicinal moss off the wall and some silver coins in the gap before the door. In the next room a door is covered by those ferns. I open a chest containing the file The Sealing Chains, which explains that the chain the statue is holding at the entrance also keeps the door to the master's lair chain shut. I have to find a point of connection and smash it. These points are behind sealed doors requiring the Araklos chain to open, the same door covered by ferns. I climb up a ladder, chain up some rocks and climb up. I go up more stairs to find the chained up door. Up here I find the file Treetop Master. This tells of the creation of the Treetop Master and where its flesh can be found. Next to it I find a panacea, a strong healing item. I go through the door on the right and see a large flower. The file Treetop Ferns is also in here. It basically says that the only way to deal with it is to kill this mother plant here. I shoot the chain at it and it sinks and escapes under the door. Outside I latch it again and give it a good yank to hurt it before it runs off again. I drop down to the previous room using the two ends of the chain to keep the plant tethered in one spot and keep hitting it until it dies. This removes all the ferns. To open the door behind it I attach a chain and keep pulling to unlock it. Inside that door is a chain which I destroyed to unlock the master's door. Outside is this plant beast with tentacles. Their attacks can poison me but they aren't a problem. Before taking on the master I return to the room I found the mother plant to loot it. I find a shard of divinity which lets me teleport out of the tower instantly. The rest of it is money. Now I can enter the master's room. It's a huge tree man that has plant life grow from its feet with each step. In this arena I find an unreadable old note in a box. The master ignores me until I chain its flesh, the glowing white part in its head. This does a little damage, but I can also hold X to build up a chain gauge to do more damage when I pull. It attacks back by making roots shoot up from the ground towards me. He can also extend branches from his arms and try to hit me with them. Pulling on his glowing hand during this with the chain will stun him and give me the chance to damage him some more. The only other move he gets to pull off is this barrier of roots. But once his health bar is empty, one more pull takes the flesh. The master tries to take it back, but dies. This also increases the chain's power, extending the bar a little. Leaving the room has me automatically return to the observatory. Mavda is waiting and tells Aaron to give it to Elena. First I can give her the unreadable old note. It's written in ancient Iosian so she can translate it for me. Then I give her the flesh. Elena collapses and has a vision of a man bringing flowers to his wife and asking her to pray that the gods of Ios end the war. She then passes out. At dawn, Eren talks with Mavda about the Master Flesh. She needs to eat all 12 pieces of Master Flesh to get rid of the curse. The next morning, I go back to Mavda to sell the spare flesh I have. The amount you make depends on the quality of the flesh. She also buys whatever files I find. Her stock also expands with every tower I clear. I just buy a medicine and a remedy for now. As I leave, she gives me another news report. This time, knowledge of the curse is spreading through Illyria. Up the stairs, on Elena's desk, is the file conquering the curse. It's written by Elena simply repeating the conditions of the curse. In the basement, I find an unreadable old note and an unreadable old text. I try to give Elena these texts, but the game demands I give her a gift just so I know how. I give her the lamp. This leads to a scene of Elena admiring it. There are many little scenes like this you can unlock by giving Elena gifts or becoming closer with her. They all count towards the game's percentage. Now I can request a translation. I can also have her slightly recap the way here. She also worries about the army finding them here since they used to work here. After that, I go to sleep to restore my health. I go to leave and get another scene where Elena asks Eren to promise her he'll be careful. Elena's a weird kind of not silent but kind of protagonist. He will talk and say the most basic things when it wouldn't make sense for him to be quiet, but most of the time he stays silent. Elena makes him perform the Vow of Ios, where they link index fingers and make a promise, but Eren's too shy for that and runs out. He does stick his hand through the door and hold his finger out for a split second though. The next tower is open, but I have some other things I want to do first, so I go back to Treetop Tower. All I'm doing here is running through the tower looting and gaining experience. I see a beast with a purple mist aura. These are far stronger than regular versions. They deal more damage and have more health, but to make up for it they give more experience. Their appearances are random, but I believe they are more common at night, at least they were in my experience. Depending on where you attach the chain to a dead enemy, the item may change. Here I messed up and latched onto its leg for a large bone. I also remember that I forgot to empty my unneeded items into the trunk, so my capacity is full. I have 30 spots for items in my bag right now. Usually when I end up with a full bag, it's the less useful items that get dropped. The dryad berries, the bodily fluids, the strange grains. After taking the lift to the second floor, I take another next to it. There's two locked red doors up here and either a honeycomb or one of the giant plants. While up here I reach level 3. There's also a chest up here with some mercury. I also find the file Treetop Purple Mist explaining what I've already explained. While higher up I check my status and find I'm actually level 4 and I don't know where I missed a level. In the room with the chain I find a sage stone. If you have these equipped it will be used to revive you if you're killed. Equipping items is on a grid, a bit like the inventory in Resident Evil 4. In the room where I found the mother plant, I find a dawn chorus. As the name implies, it only appears around dawn. Best chance to get it is to wake up at 5 a.m. as it takes an hour to arrive at the tower. By the master's door, I find another good healing item, the elixir. After reaching the top, I go back down and kill any newly spawned enemies. I reach level 5 on the way back down. I finally remember I can climb up at this height and find some gunpowder and open the chest for some more mercury. While climbing, I see a chest I can't reach. We won't be getting that for a long time. I then stand and wait for Elena's curse to progress. Once the bar reaches the blue part, I return to find that she's fine. That's annoying actually, not what I was going for. I believe this is because the game is teaching me about giving Elena flesh and it overrode the curse this time. So I leave and return to the tower. The flesh from my first visit dried out on the way back, so I just have to get one more piece first. While doing so, I reach level 6 from a beast with purple mist. You can tell the curse has progressed when you get back because the music is different, the colours outside are more muted, and the affinity gauge is purple. Returning home to a transformed Elena the first time gets you a scene of her welcoming Eren back in that form. I need to do this quite a few more times for a couple more scenes. I was hoping to give her a regular beast flesh to feel the curse gauge less and have me waiting less, but after they dried out all I could get was a dripping flesh. I would have also made much more money from Mavda. Strangely, Mavda buys all files from you, including the ones she gives you herself. Using a lump of metal and a piece of mercury, I get my sword its first upgrade. You don't have to do the upgrades in numbered order. As long as you had the parts, you could say get upgrade 6 before upgrade 3. This time I remember to empty my bag. Back to Treetop Tower. I get my first pulsating flesh, the most effective form of flesh. This one refills the curse gauge completely. I get a beast fang by attaching the chain to its head and pulling it after it dies. I climb up and find the file Treetop Plant Food talking about the giant plant enemies. Less than a minute later I kill one of those beasts to reach level 7. Even the little guys can have the purple mist. They're probably worse with it with all the quick attacks. In the next room, another purple mist beast gets me to level 8. This time, instead of waiting still when I reach the bottom, I do some more fighting to gain more experience. I reach level 9, fighting a honeycomb. This time when I return, Elena is trying to clean up the slime her own transformed body is leaking onto the floor. I give her a beast flesh. For giving Mavda 410 liots worth of flesh, she gives me mercury and a power stone, which when equipped increases attack power. At some point during that I also found a crystal ore, which along with one mercury and one lump of metal, gets me the sword 2 upgrade. I rest to restore my health. I talk to Elena who translated the 3 files for me. I get Vessel Testament 1, the Chain of Destiny, and the Chain's meaning. The Chain of Destiny simply tells me what I already know about the Vestra. The chain's meaning tells a story of someone who met Mavda. She told them that the two ends of the Heraklos chain represent light and darkness, and masculine and feminine. This Old Testament one is written by someone who was in despair over endless war and the famine it brought. Wanting the power to change the world, they'd volunteered to become a vessel. Back to Treetop Tower. I reached level 10, killing one of the little plants. The cap is 50, by the way. I reached level 11 from a small beast with purple mist. I returned to Elaine after she transformed to give the flesh. I buy a tactical manual from Mavda, thinking it's a file needed for 100%. When I go back to Treetop Tower, I remember it's a consumable item that gives you a lot of experience. 17 minutes later, I return after she's transformed to give her flesh. I must have gained levels in there, but missed them skimming through this grinding footage. I'll let you know what level I am next time I catch myself looking at the status screen. The next morning, I talk to Elena about getting used to living there. Fees give me affinity points that I don't want. Another run through Treetop Tower. This time Elena sees Aaron off and tells him to be careful, but after he leaves, she starts to feel the guilt of him going in there for her. During this run, I check my stats and see I'm level 13 at this point. Fourth time in a row I put Elena through this. From Mavda I get Sword Upgrade 3 using a lump of metal, 2 mercury and 2 crystal ore. This adds a second level of charge attack for if I wait until I glow twice while charging. And back to Treetop Tower for more time wasting. This time I get a new scene where a shambling Elena is trying to cook Aaron a meal despite the slime leaking into it, but she can't even hold a ladle in this form. Aaron tries as best he can to comfort her before I give her some flesh. I'll still need to do this some more, but for now I'm finally going to the second tower, Sheer Drop Spire. First thing I do is go left for some sticky mud. The statue of the god this time has the symbol of Earth. I can also see that I need to destroy 2 chains to reach the master this time. The path left has a red door, meaning I can only take the door in the back. In this room I meet my first beast with a sword. He isn't that much harder than the regular beast that's backing him up, but then again, I am far over level for this part. I attach the chain to this lever and keep pulling to take the lift to the top. I then go through the door. Take out another beast that gets me to level... something. To the right I get my first file here, Sheer Drop on Ore. It says that this tower has a lot of ore deposits to mine from. It also has clay layers that ore can attach to. I go left and hook across these gaps. Across the gap is another file, Sheer Drop Gold Ore. It explains gold ore, but I can do that myself when we get to it. I then go through the door. In here are some wolves. The game tells me I can use the chain to bind 2 of them together. Striking an enemy linked to another will also damage the other. Aside from the regular wolf stuff you'd expect, they can also spit fireballs. Thanks to my levels, they don't last long. I then go outside and chain onto this ore embedded in clear to climb higher. Up here, there's a piece of ore I can mine and then swing into the clear to create my own climbing stone. From there, I chain across to another lift and go up. I then use another ore to climb higher. I ignore the lift for now and head towards this door a chain is going into. I also take out this bird that's been following me. One of the ore is holding an amethyst I take too. In this next room, I drop down a bit, take out a couple birds and drop lower, following the chain through a hole in the wall. I take out all these bats here and go through another hole in the wall to the room with the first lift where I fought the sword beast. I open the chest for a shard of divinity and open the door to destroy the first chain. On the way out, Aaron wonders how Elena is. She's sweeping, wondering how Aaron is doing. I knock down a ladder to the ground, creating a shortcut. I drop down and find a file I missed, Sheer Drop the Lifts. A bit later for that now. I return the way I came to that lift I skipped and go up. I walk past the next lift and drop down, lowering a couple more ladders on the way before following another chain through a door. This room has many monsters made of ore, but before I deal with them, I find the Sheer Drop Master file. It tells me the Master's flesh is on its back. These monsters are explosive, so throwing one into another takes both out in one. I get my first oil from one of them. This unlocks the door and I can move on. In this next room, I open a chest for a Sage Stone before sliding across this gap. I then chain onto this hook and swing to the next door. I go in and destroy the other chain. I return to the lift I skipped and go up. I see I need an ore though, so I get one and bring it back up. I then lower a ladder so I don't have to do it again and swing across to the master's door. I head to the back of the master and wake it up by pulling on its flesh. It attacks first by trying to crush me with its claws. I get an unreadable old note while the master starts creating rocks on the ground and then smashing them with one giant rock. I just have to keep getting behind him and pulling at his back. He makes it hard with his jumping around and blocking me with rock formations. That's about it though, not the most interesting boss. I pull his flesh out, get my chain upgraded and leave. Elena's curse progressed quite a bit in the time I was out. She's nowhere in the living room. There is a file on the desk though, a slip of the pen. It's a letter from Elena to a family, where she talks about how Aaron and her are making a life together there. But he stops as she starts considering marriage. As for Elena, there's a slime trail leading into the cellar. I find an unreadable old note, and Elena in the middle.
Aaron, don't worry. I'm fine. Absolutely fine. I promise.
Elena.
Aaron, I'm fine, really. Don't.
This is what happens if you let Elena's gauge empty to the last quarter. I didn't intend to let it get this bad right now, but I would have needed to get this scene eventually for 100%. I give her the flesh. This time she dreams of the couple talking about how so many people in their village are dying from the famine brought on by the war, including their neighbour's child. Later that night, Mavda checks in on them. Elena brings up her dreams, how the towers were in them but without the scar underneath them. Mavda decides to look into it. The next morning, Elena's bed is empty and Aaron can hear singing. But first I sell my flesh and files to Mavda. I buy a leather belt from her. She gives me the file Bounty on her head that tells of the bounty put on Aaron and Elena by the army. People from Elena's village have been questioned and they have heard that Aaron was a soldier from the kingdom of Athos. Athos is a neighbouring country that was at war with Illyria for years, so they think Aaron is a spy and are calling for an attack on Athos as revenge. I head outside to check on Elena and watch her sing. Since it's the same song, Aaron remembers the Harvest Festival while the narrator lets us know that this is the year 511 of the Unified Era. We then basically see what we already know. After she stops, Elena talks about how happy she was to be chosen as the festival maiden, before the curse struck. Aaron once again remembers the confusion and being found by Mavda. Aaron promises to himself that he'll never let Elena transform again. I am going to make him break that promise. I give Elena the files for translating and give her the leather belt I bought. She uses it to add 10 extra item slots to my bag. I then return to Sheer Drop Spire to basically do what I did after I finished Treetop Tower. In the outdoor area, I drag an ore down to the bottom and use it to climb to this little platform for a diamond. Before the first lift in this area, I jump into this middle bit I skipped the first time. I find the Sheer Drop Explosion file that talks about those enemies made of explosive ore. I spawn another level here. From what I saw later on, I believe this is me hitting level 16. Thanks to the last flesh Elena had being a master flesh, I'm in here for a while. 25 minutes it took to get her to transform again. I give her some flesh and give the rest to Mavda. The 430 Leots worth I give her has to reward me with a panacea and a pot of dryad. That's a gift for Elena, so it gets put in the trunk until it's safe to give the presents. I get the Sword 4 upgrade for 3 lumps of metal, 1 mercury and 2 oil. After resting I get Vessel Testament 2 and Eternal Blessings from Elena. Vessel Testament 2 is the story of the medic who became a vessel to atone for euthanizing patients begging for death during the war. Not for the victims, so that he didn't have to hear their cries. Eternal Blessings looks to be some kind of Iosian prayer. Back to Sheer Drop Spire. I get my first fire ore from one of the walls. I mess up this time and return to the observatory just before the curse progresses. So I had to rush back to Treetop Tower for one more bit of flesh and losing all the others I'd built up. More flesh for Elena. The next morning she talks about how her mind is also affected in the transformation. Well, she can look forward to it because I'm going back to Sheer Drop Spire. 15 minutes later I'm back to cure her again. This time I go back to Treetop Tower to get at least one more Dawn Chorus. When I return, Aaron sees Elena scratching at her mutated parts, trying to tear them off. When she notices Aaron is here, she just smiles and apologises for the mess. I give her the flesh. I only need to have her transform one more time. That last Dawn Chorus was to make a mercury of Mavda to be used along with an Infwater and 2 tough pelts from the wolf beasts on making a tanned leather. I give it to Elena to expand my bag to 50 item slots. Next I choose to move on to the third tower, Wellspring Steeple. 2 chains to destroy again and this time the God of Violence has the symbol of water. Only one door in the back of this room, it leads to 2 walkways with a giant unmoving water wheel in the middle. I take out the sword beast, head to the right and swing across to deal with another. There are 3 doors on this side and I take the one furthest from the screen. The door locks behind me and I have to take care of these beasts that jump out of water to dive at me. The first one I kill gets me a level up and I pull my first tough scale from it. They have a water spitting attack that gives me a size effect that lowers my attack damage. While finding the last one, I open the chest in here for a shard of divinity. I then kill the last one and leave the way I came. The door next to it is locked from the other side, so I'm going through the one closest to the screen. I pull this large box so I can climb up to the staircase. I go up the mall and through the door at the top leading to the second level of the water wheel room. Not much to do other than go left through the next door. Here there's a gap that's just too big to jump across. I grab the box of the chain, pull it further down and use it to make the jump. In the bottom right corner is the first file of this tower, Wellspring Watergate. It talks about the water wheel and how to operate it. I then go up the stairs and through the door. This takes me to the top level of the water wheel room. I head forward, side load this gap and open the chest for a new weapon, the Twin Blades. These are faster than the Ephosian sword, but weaker. I stick with the sword for now. I then use the chain to pull out this switch. Nothing happens yet but the camera points out another. At the gap I just crossed, I drop down and enter the door with a chain going through it. In this room is my first armoured beast with a large lance. These can be a pain to deal with while they have backup. I aim the chain at its helmet and destroy it. This must be done to be able to damage it. After that it just takes a lot of hits to kill, even with me this overleveled. I go past the red locked door and open the sealed door to destroy the first chain. Aaron thinks about Elena again. She's just translating for him right now. I go back to the water wheel room from the door I exited from, follow the floor left to another door. This room is another set of stairs. Next to the door is the file Wellspring the Wheel. This is just background info on how and why the wheel was built. I drop down to the bottom and open up that locked door back on the first floor. I then go through the door at the top of the stairs. Here I can pull the switch on the other side to activate the water wheel. There are parts I can attach to with the chain while the wheel moves. I then ride it around until I can hook and swing to this door at the top. I find my first Vitalium, which I never use, and through the door I find Mobilium, which I also never use. These are for temporary stat boosts. Going up these stairs, I check and see I'm level 18. By the door at the top, I find the file Wellspring My Fish, talking about fish beasts we'll be seeing very soon. As in the next room. There's a huge rising tower of water in the middle of this room. In said water is the fish beasts. They swing by quick, but give me just enough time to pull them out of the water with the chain and kill them. In the other corner of this room is the Wellspring Master File. There are bits of hookable wall that travel up the water tower that I can ride up. The first one I ride up takes me to the next sealed door. I find a rainbow scale in here and destroy the last chain. I then ride a wall up to another door. This takes me outside. I walk past the boss door for now and go through the door on the other side. This just leads me back into the previous room for a panacea. Time to take on the master. The flesh travels along this master's body along with these little tracks. While I get my first hit in, he gets me with a stream of water. You can also fire these slow moving water orbs that you can destroy with the chain. I also make sure to get the unreadable old note in here. But yeah, those are his only two attacks until he reaches half health. Then he grows out some tentacles that he tries to stab me with. The water attacks also become more frequent. His last attack is this big tantrum with all four tentacles. But this one is kinda easy, if time consuming on the first try, and I take his flesh and get my chain upgrade. Before I help out Elena, I pick up the file On Beast Flesh from her desk. This is Elena writing down how the three levels of flesh work, but I've already explained that. There's also the file The Cellar, basically telling me that I can find files down there. She gets up to greet me, but I ignore her and go to the cellar. I find reconstruction plans, saying that the towers were left in disrepair for 450 years, but 50 years ago the Illyrian army started reconstructing it into a military base to defend from any possible threats from Athos. This reconstruction involves harnessing the Master's powers. Now Elena can have the Master Flesh, but this raises my affinity with her to the next level. This won't do. By now she's still not enjoying eating flesh, but she's at least getting used to it and no longer gagging. This time she dreams of the couple from the first dream and their son, Reuben. Reuben is asking his father to make him a toy soldier to go with his horse. Both Reuben and his father look very familiar. His parents can be seen doing the vow of Ios and talking about how happy they are. Once again, Mavda checks on us the next morning. She's been researching and believes that Elena's dreams are linked to the Masters whose flesh she's eaten. I have a few questions to ask her now. She tells me that the Masters are living weapons created 50 years ago, around the time the reconstruction began actually. They were created from the Illyrian army's experiments on living things. She still doesn't know why Elena is dreaming though. She says that the sky is rumoured to lead to the Otherworld, and that the rarer items I find in the towers are Otherworld items. I think this is actually the last time we ever hear about any Otherworld. When she's done, I sell her my flesh and files. She has new stock thanks to doing shady business with the Illyrian army. She's not telling them about us though, of course. She says although they want to find us, they don't have time. They're still having skirmishes with Athos despite the supposed peace between them. The 320 liots of flesh, she gives me quality metal and a sage stone. I get the Twin Blades 1 upgrade for a tough scale, amethyst and mercury, along with Twin Blades 2 for 2 tough scales, a diamond and a crystal ore. Finally, she gives me the news file, Water Rage Again, about a planned retaliation against Athos for the Harvest Festival, accusing the incident of being a plan to murder their monarch. I give Elena the text of the translation. Now to lower Elena's affinity back to below level 1. I just keep trying to give her something she doesn't like, such as this large bone. Every time I try to give it to her, affinity drops. I do that for a bit and when I go to leave, Elena reminds Aaron of the time they met 3 years earlier. Aaron escaped from a battle with Valyria and collapsed near a village close to Helicon, the Imperial capital. Elena then found him unconscious and took him home. Her parents weren't thrilled with her bringing an enemy soldier home, but agreed she couldn't just leave the wounded man to die. When Aaron wakes up, Elena promises him he's safe with her. Back in the present, Elena once again apologises for him having to go into the towers. I repay that apology by returning to Wellspring Steeple to get the last transformation cutscene. This time I want to empty the gauge as far as I can without getting a game over. I hit level 19. I also swapped to the Twin Blades just so they see a bit of use, but I prefer the sword so I swap back. I also reached level 20 killing the monster that made me swap back. I return when the gauge reaches the red but find it's still only the second phase of transformation. That's 35 minutes of flesh collecting lost. So it's another detour to the treetop tower for more flesh. Now when I go back she's reached the third phase of the curse. This time she's in the courtyard.
Elena.
Oh.
Been waiting. It's good to see you.
Not gonna lie, this one is pretty disturbing. Luckily for her, this is the last scene to unlock regarding transformations. I don't have to deliberately do this again. After I rest, Elena gives me the translated Vessel Testament 3. This one is a story of a ship captain who became a vessel after becoming tired of seeing the young sent off to die in war. No more time wasting slash grinding sessions now, it's time for the fourth tower, Crimson Keep. This time the god of Ios has the symbol of fire. I take the door on the left to a mostly dark room filled with wolves. The game teaches me the chainswing attack which demolishes most of them. One gets a fireball on me, giving me a burn status that slowly deals damage over time. After killing them all, I find the file Crimson Torches. It tells me of moths that are attracted to torches around here and that any unlit torches I find can be lit using burning coals. The other door in here takes me to some stairs. The door at the top takes me to a dark room with some burning coals. I drag some out and take them to the first unlit torch I find. During this I get moths after me and I find Crimson Red Beasts in the box. It talks about large red beasts with malleable bodies that we'll be seeing later. I then slam the coal into the torch to light it. I light the next torch in front of this door, then climb along the rocks next to it. On the other side I find some sacred ashes. I then return to the door and go through it. I find an inferno bomb, an attack item in the bottom right corner of this room before I follow the chain to the next door. The next room contains the red beasts mentioned in the file. They throw fireballs at me and grow larger when left. I have to keep pulling them with the chain until they shrink to death. They mostly drop oil but have a rare chance of dropping a crystal ore. When they're gone I can open the sealed door and destroy the first chain. Meanwhile Elena is struggling to reach a book in the cellar that she thinks will help. I go back another room and find my first tiger beasts. They only manage to get a couple claw swipes out before I kill them. I return to the dark room and climb across the rocks again. I light another torch and go through the door next to it, taking me outside. I reach level 21 here from a tiger with purple mist. I then climb up to this lever which when pulled reveals some hooks. I'm on a timer though while the lever moves back. I get up there and lower a ladder. I then enter the door into this foundry. There's a row of fire blocking the centre path and the left path, but the chain can reach this lever through the fire which turns off that fire. I get a paralysis bomb from the boxes behind it. I then pull on the other lever here to turn off the fire in the middle path but I get distracted by enemies and run out of time. I get through and reach the ladder next time. I chain over to these handles and make my way across to this ladder I chain up to. I climb up and chain across to the second sealed door. I first hit a switch that turns off all the fire, find the Crimson Master file next to it, and unlock the door. I destroy the chain and unlock the master door. From the ladder I swing across to more handles but falling molten metal knocks me off and respawns me at the door. I make it across next time, chain onto a grate and reach the higher level of this room. I then lower a ladder for a shortcut. From the middle I climb up to the right and swing across to another platform. I open the chest for some mercury and go through the door. This takes me back outside. I can swing from here but the high pressure steam would knock me off. So I first pull a lever to get rid of this firewall, then climb up to another that turns off the steam. I can now swing up to the master door. First I pick up a detonation ore to the left before going in. I swing across to the area in the middle, get another unreadable old note and pull on the flesh in the master's middle. He wakes up and dives into the lava. He attacks by breathing fire at me and even manages to knock me off the arena. To reveal the flesh again I have to use a chain to put out the different flaming segments of his body. The head, both shoulders and both arms. At this point he'll start creating flaming swords and swinging them at me. After the fires are out I can get some damage in before he goes back into the lava and gets it back. Now he'll start punching the ground and creating fire tornadoes. Two more full power chain yanks and I have his flesh and a bigger chain gauge. Since I did all that in one visit, Elena is back to a second transformed state. On the shelves I find an unreadable old text and the courtyard on Elena's desk which says I can get dryad berries from the birds there. In the cellar I find a wandering people which says that the Vestry were forced from their homeland and forced to carry the Oraculus chain for the last 500 years while it weakened. 50 years ago they worked with Valyria in exchange for assistance regaining their homeland. I then give Elena the flesh. Her dream has the husband return home with very little food thanks to the famine. They give most of the food to Reuben, pretending they just aren't hungry to not worry him. Meanwhile they worry because food will become even scarcer as the war goes on. After Elena passes out she dreams of the Harvest Festival and wakes up in shock to discover she's torn up her bedsheets in her sleep. Meanwhile Aaron pretends to be asleep, having heard everything. Then some footage got corrupted. I can tell that for giving Mavdra the 500 liots of flesh I got a music box, an ambrosia and a guardstone. I get Twin Blades 4 by using two rainbow scales, a crystal ore and some mercury. This time the report she gives me is the Curse's Mark, written by the Vestra, that lists the symptoms of the curse we already know about. I give Elena the text I need translating, I then go back to Crimson Keep because I feel I missed something. I check out the back room behind the statue at the beginning. This is the outside room I lowered the ladder earlier, but there were actually multiple ladders to lower on the way down so the shortcut is still unavailable. In the dark room I missed a chest with the Shard of Divinity, but that footage was also corrupted. I go down the ladder I lowered earlier and lower some more to create the shortcut. I also find the file Crimson the Furnace. That information is also useless to me now. Higher up in the foundry, I find Crimson the Vents, also useless to me now. That's all I find and I return to the observatory. I get a new scene where Elena finds Elena already waiting for him while singing. She can also start having pulsating flesh now, since I want all the time I can get for the next few towers. She's starting to smile now while eating it. That's worrisome. She also translated some texts. This Old Testament 4 has a blacksmith become a vessel after seeing an enemy soldier killed by a weapon he forged and feeling responsible. The 12 Laws talks of the 12 Laws of Ios. They actually refer to the light and dark sides of the six elements that make up the world. Wood, earth, fire, water, metal and light. Male gods of Ios govern light and the female shadow. After seeing Mavda and saving, the footage froze here. If something happened in that minute and a half, I can't remember what it was. But it's a new recording now and I'm off to the fifth tower, Ironclad Turret. This time the god has three chains to break and the symbol of metal. I take the door left and kill these lizards clinging to the walls. I go up the stairs and find Ironclad the Lifts. He talks of these lifts next to it. Once I hit this switch, lifts will start moving along these tracks. I can use the chain to ride them to the door. In this room I have two beasts with helmets and chain clubs attached to their hands. Like the others, they can only be damaged after their helmets are destroyed. But first, I find a military scythe in the chest behind them. It's stronger than the sword, but slower. I'll be sticking with this from now on. I use it to kill both beasts and go through the next door. There's a hole in the ground, but I ignore it for now and go through the door on the right. There's a switch here that changes the direction of the lift track. The lever to activate them is on the other side of the room. I ride it across and go through the door. I reach level 22 in here, killing a lance beast. I go up the stairs and through the first door I see. First thing I do is chain up this ladder for an unreadable old note in a chest. I drop down and climb another ladder at the other end of the room. I activate a switch that sets off all the pistons in this room and unlocks a door. I find a defang bomb up here and go through the door I unlocked. I hit a switch in here to activate the track. The hole leads to the room with a hole in from earlier. I use the lift to ride up to the next floor. I get another stat booster, a fortifica from a box, and go through the door, opening a chest for another shard of divinity. I then ride the lift to the top floor, where there's a switch to reverse the tracks. But the door up here is locked on the other side. I end up dropping down the hole to the bottom floor. Here I can unlock a door, creating a shortcut from the entrance. I then go through the door on the left. I take out all the walls in here and find Ironclad Expansion. It talks about a push for more weapons while Athos and two other kingdoms, Surtees and Fina, are at war with Illyria. But their machines have started stopping. I also find the Ironclad Master File. I ride the lift back up from the door I started from. I then go right and smash this orange shit to get the piston moving again. This lets me get to the sealed door so I can smash the first chain. Elena is waiting outside for Aaron to come back. She's going to be waiting a while. I then ride the lift next to the piston up. At the top I break free another piston, then jump across the gap for an abyss ingot. I then use the chain to break free another. I then drop down and take the lift on the far right of the room. I break free another piston on the way up. I hit a switch to change a track and ride further up. I ride another lift up and break free one more piston before climbing the ladder next to it. The next sealed door is here and I can smash the second chain. I then return to the room where I first learned to change a track and take the other path to the last sealed door and destroy the final chain. Time to start climbing all these pistons. I jump across one, break free another, run around to the next, jump over to a ladder, climb it, swing across a gap, climb some steps, ride a lift, break free another piston and jump across. Ride another lift up, ride a lift along to another platform and then higher up, jump across and climb up. Here I can open that locked door, creating another shortcut. I decide to use a Shard of Divinity to return to the observatory. On the shelf I find an unreadable old text and from the roof on Elena's desk, it's about the view. I then give Elena some flesh. 260 layouts of flesh from Ironclad Turret gets me a certain carpet and skill band. One's a gift so it goes in the trunk. The skill band I equip because it boosts experience earned. I get the upgrade Scythe 6 for 2 bodily fluids, 2 abyss ingots and 2 large bones. I then get Scythe 3 for 2 large bones, a beast fang and a sticky mud. I give Elena the text to translate and get back on over to Ironclad Turret. Using the 2 shortcuts I opened, I get back to where I left from in no time. I take the other door up here, head up the stairs and go through the door. I then go up the stairs to the master door. I spot a locked red door to the right before I enter. This time the master isn't waiting for me to initiate, he drops down from the ceiling. He has horizontal and vertical slashes with his 2 blades. After enough hits, his body overheats and he drops down, revealing the flesh in his abdomen. I do that twice more until he hits half health. He only really gains one new attack, a ground slam that has rocks fall from the ceiling. It merely just becomes more aggressive, keeping up attacks for longer. I keep up the strategy until I have that flesh. When I return, Elena's desk has the files The Mark on My Back and Text Index. The seller has the final experiment, which details discovery on the creation of the Masters by researching the Arachos chain. However, they then decided to cut ties with the Vestra, feeling that their ancestors relied on them too much. It ends on the plan to use a human for the final 13th Master. I then give Elena the Master Flesh. She's actually enjoying it and licking her lips now. That's more worrisome. This time she dreams of the creation of the Scar, hearing a woman's voice talk about sacrifice. Later that night, Aaron dreams of a time when Elena cut his hair, using the dirtiest looking comb I've ever seen. Aaron overhears the comments from neighbours about them, but Elena doesn't care. When she asks if anyone in Athos has hair like his, Aaron instead remembers being in a war zone, terrified. That memory wakes him up. From Mavda, I get Scythe upgrade 1 for a large bone, Witcher's Wand and Mercury, unlocking its second charge attack. She gives me Tightening Borders, a report about the Harmony tightening Illyria's borders to stop Aerion and Elena from fleeing the kingdom. At some point I also hit level 23 but missed it. This time, 5 more towers have opened at once, but first I need to go back to Ironclad Turret. I return to the Master's room and drop down below to find the unreadable old note. On the way out, I hit level 24. When I return, Elena is waiting for me, asking for flesh like a junkie. She snaps out of it and I give her more to translate. She also apologises for making everyone think he's a criminal and promises to clear his name when they return to her village. I can take on the next 5 towers in any order I want, but I'll just go in list order, starting with Arcadian Tower. As we can see by the preview, it looks very similar to the Treetop Tower. This time, the statue is of a goddess of Ayas with the wood symbol. The next 5 towers are parallels to the first 5, but now we're representing the shadow side of the 12 laws with the goddesses. As an extra touch, all the songs that had the male choir now have a female choir in these towers. The door on the left is locked, so I go through the door in the back. I ignore the lift in this room for now and go through the other door. It leads to a kind of storeroom with cocoons that hatch into giant moths. They send out poison spores, but are easy to beat down. I end up getting poisoned by one's regular attack though. I also get a poison bomb from a box. There's a red locked door in here, so I start climbing. I find the file Arcadian Toxic Moths. Already dealt with them. The next lift, next to the one I used, is covered in yellow thorns. I go through the door and swing across to the other side, passing another red locked door on the way. Through the next door, the room is covered in purple thorns. Can't do anything in here, so it's onto the next room. In here, I reach level 25, killing a moth. The next room has both the yellow and purple mother plants. The yellow one is guarded by purple thorns, so I have to deal with the purple one first. I chase it back 2 rooms and kill it, getting rid of the purple thorns. After brain farting and forgetting where I was going, I return to this room and find a setting sun on the floor. I push this box to climb up to a chest containing the file Arcadian Thorns. Another one that's just a bit too late. With the purple thorns gone, I take on the yellow mother plant. This one doesn't leave the room before I kill it. With the thorns gone, I drop down to the room below to be met by electric wolves. Their electricity doesn't do them any good and they die quick. Down here, I open up the door back to the entrance and then open the sealed door to destroy the first chain. While this is going on, Elena is tidying up Aaron's desk. I return to the room with the lifts and with the thorns gone, I can get an unreadable grimy note from the chest and take the next lift up. There's another lift on the next floor, but this one's covered in red thorns. The next room has nothing big in it. The room after has blue thorns surrounding its mother plant. I manage to provoke it into escape into one of the next rooms. The very next room has me reach level 26 from another moth. The mother plant is in the next room with one of those large plant beasts and 2 of the smaller ones. I manage to chain up the mother plant and kill it quickly. With the blue thorns gone, I kill the rest of the enemies and go back 2 rooms. With no more blue thorns, I can open the sealed door and destroy the second chain. I return to the room I killed the blue plant in and keep going. I go up another staircase and find the Arcadian Master File. Through the hole in the wall is the red mother plant, but I can't reach it. Instead there are these plant bombs on the ground I can grab and throw at it. It only moves along that tree root up there so it doesn't take long to kill. That's all thorns removed. They were also blocking the last sealed door, so now I can destroy the final chain. Elena's curse cage is getting empty, so I use the Shard of Divinity to walk back and give her the flesh. I rest until Elena wakes up to get the translated Vessel Testament 5 and the Vow of Ios before giving her the new stuff to translate. Vessel Testament 5 has a man become a vessel due to being sick of fighting in wars and killing others. The Vow of Ios is one of those lover dies at war, spirit visits in their sleep stories that is the origin of the linking fingers. I get back to the tower. With the red thorns gone, I can now take the next lift up and go through the door. I fight my way through the next room to the door, picking up my first corrosion bomb and reaching level 27 from a small beast with purple mist. In the next room, I find a gleaming amber and enter the master's room. I get the unreadable old note first thing. For this master, I have to pull her out of the light in the back of the room and keep hitting her while avoiding her swipes. After enough hits, the flesh reveals itself and I can get to pulling it. During this, she also spits out the plant bombs. Eventually, she'll escape to the light to hide her flesh again and I'll have to repeat the process. Once she reaches half health, she gets some more devastating swipes with a bigger area of effect. But the strategy stays the same until I yank out that flesh and get my chain upgrade. Elena gives me the Alchemy Teachings too she translated just in time for me to give her more to translate before stuffing her face with Master Flesh. This put her affinity up to level 2, gotta deal with that again. In this next dream, Reuben's mother is desperately trying to find him. A bystander tells her he went to the main street to watch a soldier's march. She finds his horse toy destroyed. He dropped it, went to pick it up, and the horse trampled him to death. No one even tried to help him, not wanting to interrupt the march. The dream ending on his mother's screams of despair. This time, just before passing out, she starts to crave more flesh before coming to her senses and wondering what's happening to her. The next morning, Aaron wakes up to find Elena missing. I head up to the roof and find her standing at the edge, overlooking the scar in a trance. Aaron's shouting snaps her out of it and she backs away in terror and starts crying. She blames herself for the situation and starts scratching her arms enough to make them bleed. As someone who has been in Aaron's position for this latter part, seeing that happen many times in the last few years, it hit close to home. When she asks if Aaron still loves her even when she's a beast, he simply replies by performing the vow of Ios with her. They then return inside. From Mavda, I get Scythe upgrade 5 using 2 bodily fluids, 2 sacred ashes and some mercury. She gives me a file named The Scar. What we do learn in this is that the army denies the existence of the towers, simply saying that the area is too hazardous for civilians. They based themselves there 60 years ago, but then sealed off the towers 50 years ago after some cataclysm happened. After that, I keep trying to give Elena another large bone to lower affinity. One last tower for this episode with Rock Shard Rampart. As you can guess, this is a harder equivalent of Sheer Drop Spire. The door in the back is a blue locked door, meaning I can only go through the door on the right. I go up the stairs and through the door. This takes me outside. I have more raw shenanigans to do here. I have to get a piece from the wall, break it in two, put a piece into the wall, chain over to it to open the chest for the file Rock Shard Mining, then throw the other piece into the edge of the higher up wall and climb up. Up here there's more orange shit to destroy to free a lift which I use to get even higher. The first enemy I kill after getting off it raises me to level 28. After this is another new enemy, these pillbugs. They have armoured masks so you have to hit from behind to do damage. I take the next lift up but it doesn't go very far, so I move on. I then take the next lift to the top and swing across. I walk past a red locked door and use R to climb across to the first sealed door already. I destroy the chain and we see what Elena's up to again. She's looking in the cellar again for more bugs to help. I go back the way I came, drop into the gap I swung over to the hallway below. There's only a locked door here, but suddenly a Minotaur bursts through that door. He can hit me with his horns. In fact, that's all he pulls off before I kill him. I go through the doorway he opened to find another red locked door, but there's also an Aurin here, which I miss and go looking around, dropping myself into the abyss. This respawns me at the sealed door where I see a ladder I missed, so I lower it and climb down. I then go through the door. There is another red locked door here and a hole leading outside. The lift is stuck further up, so I have to use the chain to climb these pieces of white gold ore. They can't keep Aaron's weight long before crumbling, but they will respawn. When I get close to the lift, I break it free. While it lowers, I pull an Akanos stone off the wall. I keep climbing the ore to find the master's door, but there are still 2 more chains. I follow one to another door in this room. The door locks and I have to take out all the pillbugs to move forward. In this next room, I lower another ladder and use more ore to get to the sealed door. I actually get killed by a pillbug outside it. Thankfully, I had a sage stone equipped. I kill it, go inside and break the second chain. I go down the ladder and drop down to some rocks to swing to this floor just above the goddess's head. Here I reach level 29, killing a small beast with purple mist. The only door on here is locked, so I drop down and return to the first outdoor room. I raise the second lift here and destroy the ore under it so it can lower further, taking me to a chest containing a blast stone. I grab an ore from below and try carrying it all the way up to use it, but it despawns after a certain point. I'm stumped, give up, and return to the observatory. In the cellar, I find the Cataclysm, talking of the final experiment that failed and created the scar. Thousands of people working in the towers were killed during this. The survivors are confused at how the towers remain and how they got chained to the land. I give Elena the flesh. From Mavdra I get Twin Blades upgrade 3 using a tough scale, amethyst, diamond and 2 lumps of metal. After resting I go back in. I finally notice that ore I missed and as soon as I pull it free another Minotaur bursts through the opposite wall. Killing it gets me to level 30. I pull some ore out into the hallway and use it to climb this wall. At the top I get the Rock Shard Master file. I then use the white gold ore to follow the chain down to the bottom and through the door. Here I can open the locked door leading just above the goddess. I then drop down and unlock the door behind the goddess at the entrance. I pull some more into the lift to take it up and use it to reach the sealed door. There I destroy the last chain, and I already know where the master's door is. But first I take an ore up this lift and use it to reach this room. It has the Rock Shard Minotaur file. I make it back to the master's door and grab a shadow ore off the wall. I get the unreadable old note and the master bursts from the ground underneath me. Silly her, that exposes me to the flesh on the back of her head right away. Whenever you start dealing flesh damage, she starts walking to the wall and climbs it to make me fall off. When she lands, she lays an egg that I fling at her. This makes the bottoms of her legs glow. I keep hitting the legs to make them fully glow. When the legs are all fully glowing, she falls over. I then have to chain onto her tail, wait until she gets up, then drop on her back to get back to the flesh. I can also hurt her legs further to slow her walk to the wall. Just keep this up until she loses half her health. Like the others, she's now more aggressive. She tries crushing me under her legs and running me over. Now the egg she lay explode into many shards, but just keep it up and pull that flesh out. I return to Elena who has finished translating Vessel Testament 6 and Alchemist Duty 1. I give her more to translate and the Master Flesh. This time her dream is about the strain Reuben's death has had on his parents. His mother still makes him a meal every day to help herself cope, but it's causing his father much pain. Even then, they still know they have each other. That night, Elena gives me a file she found, Ancient Masters. It reveals that the masters I've been fighting are attempt to recreate previous masters from 500 years ago, and that the Vestra helped. So we call him Mavda. She confirms that the current masters were based on older masters from 500 years ago. She clearly knows more, but isn't giving out much useful information. She leaves, and Elena wonders if they can even trust Mavda. The next morning, I get a tactical manual for giving Mavda 270 Leos of flesh. I also get Scythe upgrade 4 using 2 bodily fluids, a large bone, 3 loss of oil and some mercury. Then Scythe 7 with 3 bodily fluids, an Arcanos stone, 2 setting suns and some mercury. This gets me the Scythe's 3rd charge attack. In the cellar there's an unreadable old text I give to Elena, and that's it for Pandora's Tower this episode. I'm at exactly 50% completion. Next, I return to Pandora's Tower. If you remember from last episode, I cleared 7 of the 12 towers with 50% of the game completed. Right away, I head to the 8th tower, Torrent Peak. This one is my least favourite of the towers. It's the dark equivalent to the Wellspring Steeple. First thing I do is use the tactical manual I got last episode for an XP boost. In the entrance, there's only the one door in the back. It leads to another room with a big water wheel. This one is much more a pain in the arse than the one in Wellspring Steeple. I pull a switch and swing across to the other side of the room, then climb up the pegs on the wheel to reach the second floor. Up here there's a chest with a panacea. I go through the door next to the chest. I drop to the bottom of this room, ignore the waterfall and leave through the bottom door, taking me to the corner of the water wheel room. I go into the next door which locks behind me and I'm attacked by these membranes. They surround themselves with a bubble which can be removed by pulling on them with the Araklos chain. They also spit water that gives me a defense lowering status. They aren't much of the problem though, all three even give me a crystal ore. I swing to the other side, pick up this rainbow scale and leap through the other door. Here I pull a switch to reveal a grapple point. I use it to swing to another switch to reveal another grapple point that reaches back to this room's entrance, creating a loop I can use to get around easier. I then return to the waterfall room, climb up to the door I first entered it through and leap back into the second floor. I follow the floor around to the other side and go through the door. This one also locks behind me and next to it is the file Torrent Membrane, starring some idiot poking a membrane with a stick until it kicked his ass. In here there's some servant beasts wielding claws to take out. Killing the first one levels me up to 32. Killing the second opens the doors. I follow this next room around and find it's a dead end. The door needs to be unlocked from the other side. So I return to the waterfall room. Across from the second floor door, the waterfall has rising chunks of wall I can cling to and ride up. I swing across to the fifth level at the top and open the chest for a sage stone. Then I drop down and go through the door to reach another room with a huge torrent in the middle. Just like in Wellspring Steeple, there are fish beasts swimming around it and chunks of the wall to cling to and ride up. Instead I go through the door on the other end of this room to a room of stairs. Nothing big in here, just some common items. Back in the torrent room I get climbing. I drop off in front of the sealed door I unlock and destroy the first of 3 chains. Back at the observatory, the curse is messing with Elena and ruining her translating. Next I ride over to this room with water floating near the ceiling and some membranes to kill. In the chest I find the file Torrent Master. I then climb up to the door on the top floor. This leads up to the master door but of course I'm still missing 2 chains. So I return to the waterfall room and drop to the door on the third level that I missed, thinking the previous floor I was on was the third floor. To the left is another locked red door, but to the right is a set of water gate levers. One's already been pulled out. Pulling out the other opens the gate and gets the wheel moving. However, unlike the Wellspring Steeple, this one doesn't keep moving. I have to release the lever to position the wheel how I want it so I can climb to where I want. This is why this tower is my least favourite. It's such a pain having to come back here every time I need to adjust the wheel if I did something wrong. I return to the first floor and climb the newly adjusted wheel up to a corner of the second floor I couldn't reach before. To the left of the door is the torrent restoration file. I then go through the door and open the sealed door to destroy the second chain. I also unlock that locked door from earlier. At this point I decide it's best to leave and give Elena some flesh. Not before spending ages fighting 2 beasts with purple mist. I was in there so long that Elena reached the second stage of the curse. For giving Mavda at least 300 liots worth of flesh, I'm giving a rainbow scale and a farsight band which when equipped has items visible from further away. I equip it. I get the upgrade Twin Blades 5 using 2 rainbow scales, 2 amethysts and 2 fire ore. I then get Twin Blade 6 using 3 rainbow scales, a diamond and 2 lumps of metal. This also unlocks the Twin Blade's 3rd level charge attack. I then have them make me some mercury so I can use it with a large bone and a lump of metal for the Scythe 2 upgrade. Still not done. I get some more mercury made so I can use it with an Arcana stone, 3 beast fangs and a large bone for Scythe 8. After that I finally have air and rest. He has a nightmare about how much Elaine has been enjoying eating the flesh lately. Talking to Elaine gets me the translated Vessel Testament 7 and the Price of Peace. I have the option to ask her about last night, and she asks if Aaron heard anything. I just tell her it was nothing. The Price of Peace talks about a gathering of the Elders of Ios and the Vestra tribe. The Vestra agreed to help them unite the 12 gods in exchange for being given their homeland back. At the same time, the King of Illyria doesn't trust the Vestra and swears revenge on them if it ends in failure. I forgot to read Vessel Testament 6 last time. This time the vessel volunteered after seeing the damage done to the land itself. Vessel Testament 7 is from the widow of a lord of a tribe that believes the rich must protect the poor. After her husband and son died in battle, she's next in line to protect their tribe by offering herself to the gods. After reading them, I go back to Torrent Peak. I trek back up to the water wheel and move the grapple points up to a part of the third floor I can't reach otherwise. I return to the second floor, but find the fixed camera doesn't allow me to see the grapple points. This is why I hate this fucking wheel. The position I put it in would make complete sense, but the fixed camera, which has never been a problem until this point, stops me from using it. After some aimless wandering, I have them start in the section of the second floor I found in the second chain. For whatever reason, I go back down to the first floor and reach level 33, killing a membrane. When I come to my senses, I go through that blue door I unlocked to reach the grapple points, and the chain doesn't connect for whatever reason, and I fall to the first floor. But it's fine, because a beast knocks me into the water and I respawn back on the second floor. You'd think I wouldn't grapple to the swinging point first again, but no. So I drown myself to get back up there. Turns out if I just walk down the screen a little, it would allow me to grapple the higher up point on screen. Now I can reach the next sealed door on the third floor, pick up the vest room water inside, and destroy the final chain. Clearing out enemies for experience on the way to the Master, I reach level 34. Just before heading into the area with the Master door, I pick up some goddess tears from the wall. I then enter the Master's room. I first pick up the unreadable old note and then head toward the centre so that the Master descends from the flooded ceiling. She has little spikes I can grab that shoot slow water balls at me. I can grab onto them and tear them off. After the first one, she creates a cyclone of water and rises back up. When she returns from the water, she has regrown the segment I tore off. So I keep pulling off segments. Ones that don't contain the flesh reveal tentacles that will either slap at me or fire water balls. Eventually I reveal the flesh. Can't get the time to stand still and build up the chain meter with all these projectiles, so I'm gonna have to just keep plinking health away with weak tugs. Eventually it will travel to a different segment and then the Master will get back up in the water and the cycle will start again. In the second cycle I manage to build up a full meter only for the flesh to move just before I can use it for the big pull. As usual, she becomes more aggressive when half of their health is gone. The water blasts are much bigger and quicker than they were before. I get all my own health slapped out at one point, but I had a few Sage Stones equipped, so it's fine. Now when she rises back up, multiple Water Cyclones appear in the arena. And that's about it. It's a long and kinda boring fight. I shot on it a little by managing to build up my meter and finish off the last chunk of her health with one big yank and take the flesh. Before I give the flesh to Elena, I pick up the colours in her dream file from her desk. It talks about one of her guilt-fueled dreams. Then I go down to the cellar and give her the Master Flesh. Now she's tearing it right out of Aaron's hands to wolf it down. That's very troubling. This time, when she dreams of Reuben's parents, their neighbours have lost their child too, the war having taken the medicine that would have saved his life. His mother prays to the gods of Ios to let her and her husband have another child. They have no family left, and everyone around them is dying from famine or disease. She just wants something to make them happy again. The next morning, Elena talks about the dreams and thinks it may be possible what she's seeing is even further back than the 50 years they first fought. I give Mavden my flesh and documents. I buy some more healing items and another tactical manual since I can afford it. I buy some mercury and use it with a gleaming amber and some goddess tears for the upgrade Twin Blade 7. I then buy an Abyssinger and forge some more mercury and use them for Sword 5. Mavden also gives me the file The Scar 2. A journalist, I think, has managed to get confirmation from an elderly member of the Illyrian army that the Scar didn't exist until 50 years ago. I give Elena a note for translating. I also have a ramble about the Vestry losing their country. In the cellar I find the Master's Rage. It goes into more detail about the Elders of Ios working with the Vestra. The writer believes a failed attempt at recreating the original Masters was divine punishment for stupidity and arrogance. I also find an unreadable old text. I give it to Elena and set off to the Ninth Tower, Blazing Citadel. Of course, this is the Dark Mirror of Crimson Keep. First thing, I use a tactical manual. There's a door to the right and in the back. I choose right. The door locks behind me and I'm attacked by a giant flaming moth. It spawns smaller flaming moths too. They can breathe fire and shake off the Arachlos chain as well. What followed was a long fight with me trying to hit it when it got close to the ground and it pelted me with its children. I also get the burn status, which is just continuous damage over time. During the fight I pick up the Blazing Queen Moth file so I can read about it while it kicks my head in. Right after, I'm already losing a Sage Stone to them. The file did give me the solution though. I grab one of its children and throw them at it to stun it. This finally lets me kill it and pull an Inferno Bomb from its body. With the doors unlocked, I go through the other door in this room. This next room is another that's just stairs. I just make my way to the top and go through the next door. Here I have another dark room with burning coals and some lanterns alight. It reveals a grapple point I use to swing to the left side of the screen where there's a red locked door. After lighting all the lanterns, I swing towards the back of the screen and land on the section with the coals. I follow the little path into the back, climb up on the wall, pick up a phoenix stone and then for whatever reason, go back, swing to the door in the back and go through it, despite the fact I could see a chain. I use my chain to block the pipes blowing steam and pull a lever to make some grapple points appear. I almost get up the first time but they go away just before I can do the last jump. I get up next time though and knock down a ladder to the room reached from the back door in the entrance. I then go through the door which leads to another of these rooms. I go right at the door and find the file blazing a crack. The Master's firepower is so strong it caused a crack in the furnace. I then go left to the door, climb a ladder and then the wall. This just leads to another red locked door so I drop back down. I instead drop down the middle and jump across a platform in the molten metal. I swing across to another and climb another ladder. I knock down another ladder to create a shortcut next to the entrance. I jump across to a lever that removes a fire blocking me from a sealed door. As I reach it, I get attacked by a flaming tiger. He's not an issue, my charged scythe attack destroys him. I then unlock the door and destroy the first chain. Back at home, Elena's starting to break down a bit, waiting for Aaron. I finally choose to return to the dark room and follow that chain to another room. I follow the chain again to another room where the door locks behind me. Just some flying beasts to deal with. I do get the last of my health knocked away, but I still have another sage stone. After taking them all out, I unlock the door and destroy the second chain. After picking up a few more items, I use a Shadow of Divinity to walk back to the observatory. When I return, I find an unreadable old note on the shelf and additions to index on Elena's desk. I then give Elena some flesh. I give Mavna my remaining flesh and vials. After resting, I talk to Elena to get the translated Vessel Testament 8 and a unified god. I then give her more to translate. She's been hearing noises in the night again, so I play a little prank to lower affinity a little more. I then go back in. This time I head to the back room. In the chest I find the Blazing Master file. Also like Crimson Keep, the shortcut requires multiple ladders being lowered, so I'm still having to take the long way back. When I do get back up, I make sure to go down that ladder and lower all the others. I next return to the foundry and jump across the platforms in the middle, then chain to a ladder and climb up. I chain onto the big grapple point hanging from the middle of the ceiling and then on top of another machine. From there I climb down to pull another lever to remove the fire in front of the final sealed door, but I can't get to it. Instead I'm supposed to climb back up to the higher level and go to the left so I can grapple to this point and drop down. Then I just unlock the door and destroy the final chain. I can then swing back over to the top of the machine, grapple over to a door, lower the ladder and go through it. Back outside I swing across some grapple points while avoiding steam coming from the pipes. I reach a higher area with a ladder to lower and a lever to pull. The lever turns off an even higher steam pipe. There's a pair of ladders nearby to climb up and then I can swing to the top level and lower the last ladder before entering the master's room. The master is just flying in circles until I get close, then she tries to dive bomb me, and succeeds. She can also create fire tornadoes. I take the time to get the unreadable old note and get started on fighting her. Unlike the last master, her flesh isn't concealed, it's right in her face. Pulling on it can make her just fall on her ass and give you the chance to pull it some more. After the huge amount of damage I just did to her, she creates 6 drones and starts sending them at me. They'll also cover her face if I try chaining it. Grabbing them and pulling will destroy them though. I get her in the middle of creating them and reduce from just over half health to about a quarter. In this more aggressive phase, she'll have the drone start spinning around her and spread out towards me. I can still destroy them though. Her dive also gets stronger and is followed by the rest of them diving me. It ends up costing me another sage stone. That's about it for this fight and I tear the flesh out a few minutes later. Killing her also raised me to level 35. I then return and give it to Elena. This time she dreams of Ruben's mother seeing a representation of the power of the 12 laws of Ios. The next morning, Aaron wakes up to see Elena staring out the window, wondering what happened 500 years earlier.
Aaron.
Ugh.
We said we'd always be together, didn't we?
Well, that's curious. Later that night, Aaron is maintaining his weapons when Elena walks up from behind him and gives him a hug. Aww. Then tries to strangle him. Aww. Her eyes are red and Aaron has to push her to the ground, prompting that other voice to ask why he's here.
Elena! Please,
beg of you, Aaron.
Screams less, I've lost the love of my life, and more, I have a terrible migraine.
It is the year 511 in the Unified Era. Remorselessly, relentlessly, the curse spreads far and wide. The names of Aeron and Elena, once sought by the Illyrian army, disappear from people's memories. To this day, they say that Mavda still brings victims of the curse to the 13 Towers.
How did this happen? How could we let this happen?
Well, Aaron, it's because my affinity with Elena was too low. There are 5 endings in this game and all are required for 100%. This was the D ending, Broken Chain, for giving Elena 9 pieces of Master Flesh with an affinity level of 1 or 0. I'm booted back to the title screen and have to watch that scene again. This time, when the voice asks, "Why are you here?" the screen goes black and Mavda is heard rushing in. We next see Elena in bed and Mavda says she gave her some sleeping medicine. I have a few questions I can ask her, but they're very basic and the answers are just things we already know. Mavda says she'll try to find out what's wrong with Elena, and that Aeron should just focus on the last 3 masters. The next morning, I sell Mavda my flesh and files. I've been asleep for a few hours, so Elena is up. First, I go into the cellar to find an unreadable old text. I talk to Elena, and she's translated the people's god. I then give her even more to translate. I can ask her how long we've been here, which gets her thinking her little brothers have forgotten what she looks like. I tell her that won't be true to make her feel better. I then run back inside and give my new file to Mavda. From her, I buy an indigo rug, some flower seeds, a blue drape, cat's eye drape, tangled drape, and red drape, wiping out half my funds. I now read my translated files. A unified god once again covers the Elders of Ios meeting with the King of Illyria to discuss uniting the 12 gods and realizing they need the Oraklos chain and have to work with the Vestra. The People's God is about the war leading people away from believing in the 12 gods due to nothing getting any better, and moving towards worshipping a single god. The Elders of Ios are up in arms about it, but refuse to understand why faith in their gods is dwindling. Vessel Testament 8 is about a dancer who decided to become a vessel after her audience was sent off to fight in the war. Now I'm not trying to keep my affinity with Elena that low, I can finally give her some presents. First, I ask about her singing, to which she says she hasn't felt like it in a while. I also ask how she's doing, but she lies and says she's alright. I give her the indigo rug. This will be seen on the floor from now on. I give her the flower seeds, which she will plant, also getting back up to affinity level 1. When I give her the blue drape, she asks if she could make a bed cover or tablecloth from it. I choose tablecloth. For the cat's eye drape, I choose bed cover. For the tangled drape...
What an interesting pattern. It's really inspiring me to do something creative. Something like a bed cover or a tablecloth.
Yeah, creative. I go tablecloth, then bed cover for the red drape. She then gives me some homemade cakes for the affinity level, which I then shove in storage. I go back to Mavda and forge a white gold ring with 2 gold coins and a diamond, then a rainbow bracelet with a rainbow scale, a lump of metal, and an amethyst. I then buy a pot of dryad, a pot of geranium, and a flower implant. I then head back to Elena. First I give her the 3 plants. All 3 will now be seen around the house. Then I give her the white gold ring. She loves it and asks if Aeron has ever given anyone else a gift like this. She's thrilled to find that he hasn't. We'll be seeing her wear it from now on. Giving her the rainbow bracelet raises affinity to level 2. She'll also wear this from now on. For the affinity I get 2 homemade salves that I also chuck straight into storage. With all that done, it's time for Tower 10, True Gold Tower, the Dark Mirror of Ironclad Turret. This time, there are 4 chains to deal with. I go through the door in the back of the locks behind me. This place has even stronger versions of those hives from the Treetop Tower. The hornets this one spawns now have their own acidic projectile that lingers on the ground a bit. Apart from that, they're the same as the earlier versions. I climb to the top of these boxes and pull a switch to get a rail moving. It moves quite fast though, so I have to turn it off and time it so the grapple points stop above where I need to drop. I grapple over to another platform and then grab onto another moving grapple point and ride it up into a room filled with pistons. Very similar to another room from my ironclad turret. I head to the left and in the corner I find the file True Gold Hammers. It tells me nothing I didn't already know from my ironclad turret. On the other side of the room I find two steel ingots. I then return to the bottom floor and stop the grapple points earlier so I can get to the door with a chain above it. However, I'm foiled by the gap being too big to jump. So I head back up and go through the door. In this room was a hole in the floor I can climb down. The door here leads to the part of the bottom floor I was trying to reach before. Here I can lower a ladder to create another shortcut. There's a switch next to the door that gets another rail moving. I use it to chain lower down so I can first climb to another switch to get it moving again. And then another that changes direction so I can get to that sealed door, unlock it and break the first chain. Meanwhile, Elena is in a trance talking to herself. I return to the previous room, chain onto a ladder in the centre and start climbing another one of these rooms. Got pistons to pull out and attach to posts and others to wait for to time my jumping and climbing. I pull a lever that brings the platform over to me and then pull it again while standing on the platform to ride it to another section. There's a blue locked door here and I climb the ladder next to it to find I can't do anything here yet. Rather than climb back up, I just shout the divinity back to the observatory. Elena gives me the translator that's a Testament 9 and I can have her praise me for knowing how to save the game. Then I give her some flesh. Vessel Testament 9 shows that the Blazing Master had no tragic backstory, she was just really thrilled at the idea of being fused with a god. From Mavda, I buy pure tea leaves and a blue garb. After resting until Elena is awake, I give her the pure tea leaves, and then the blue garb. She'll now be randomly wearing this instead of her original outfit. It's very nostalgic for Elena because it's just like what she was wearing when she first met Aaron. I then go back into the tower. I pull out the first piston I can and instead go through the door. While it's slowly working its way back, I can chain up the ladder and run past it. I can then chain to another ladder leading to a chest containing some Aegis steel. This time when I pull the lever that brings over a platform, I just cross it and go up the stairs, which leads me slightly outside where I go left and down some stairs. After taking out the enemies, I open the sealed door and destroy the second chain. I then take the stairs on the right which lead me to the file True Gold Enhanced. It talks about how the master of this tower has made the weapon production more efficient. I return to the other room and time riding this grapple point so I can land on the piston. I can then climb another to hit a lever that changes the rail direction so I can ride the previous one higher and land on another piston that I drop next to and open a chest containing an unreadable grimy note. I then break free the two pistons here. Not seen was a lot of pissing around making no progress, so I walk back out. For returning home between 6 AM and 11 PM over level 30, I get a new scene where Elena welcomes Aaron home from upstairs but falls, but Aaron catches her so it's alright. She also gives me the translated Who Are The Masters just in time for me to give her more to translate. I also get her to talk about how intimidating Aaron was to her when they first met since he barely spoke at first. I then give her some flesh. From Mavda I get the Sword 6 upgrade using 2 Abyss Ingots and 2 Crystal Ore, unlocking its next charge attack. I then get Sword 7 with an Abyss Ingot, a Steel Ingot and some Mercury, then after resting I return to the tower. While I'm getting back to where I left from, I decide to read Who Are The Masters. It reinforces that the decision to create the Masters was reached from the people rejecting the religion of Ios due to the war. With those two pistons freed, I can finally ride the platform back across. I use the first one to jump across to the centre again and chain it to this post so I can wait for the second to come out and jump across. From there I ride across two rails to a lever that changes the course of the rail lower down. I can then ride that to another almost outside area that leads to the third sealed door, letting me destroy another chain. I jump across that first piston once again and then pull out and climb two more to reach the top floor of this room. I unlock a blue door up here and go through it. I go left from the door, drop into a hole and then climb across some more pistons to reach the final sealed door. I also unlock the other blue door. I unlock the sealed door and destroy the final chain. I also hit another lever next to the door to create a shortcut back up here. I return to the top floor and go through the only other door up here. The door locks behind me and there are beasts waiting for me. Nothing I can't handle at this point. In the corner is the True Gold Master file. I then go up the stairs and through the next door. This leads me right to the Master's door. I get the usual unreadable old note and start pulling on this thing blocking the Master's flesh. This sets this ring thing spinning. There's now one segment to it with a hole that I can chain and drag over to the flesh to expose it. Now I can set the rest of the master off. I do a huge amount of damage with the first yank, leading to her jumping in the air and spinning the ring again. She starts sending red things on the ground that I destroy and the other segments of the ring will start growing cannons for me to destroy. I pull the empty segment back over to the flesh and take out the second third of her health already. In a more aggressive phase, her jumps now create shockwaves for me to avoid. It also creates barriers on either side of her that I can't destroy. And the flesh is on the other side. So I just have to wait a bit until it goes and the next one she creates doesn't block me from the flesh. That's all there is really to say about this boss and 5 minutes later I had that flesh. Killing her also raised me to level 36. Back at the observatory I give Elena the master flesh. It also raises her affinity to level 3. This time she dreams of Ruben's parents hearing of the plan to unite the 12 gods of Ios. His father doesn't sound convinced by the idea but his mother is all for it, saying that the gods have been incapable of preventing the war and all the children that died from it. She intends to offer herself as a vessel. We then see an elder declare the start of Experiment Zero. The next morning, Mavda visits. She tells Elena that she's turning into one of the Masters herself. She and her husband reveal what we've already worked out by now, that the Masters were once humans, whose souls shared a place with the creatures from the Scar. Mavda has known this since the beginning. Elena thinks Mavda has tricked them, but Mavda says eating all Master flesh will absolutely cure her. She also states how impressed she is by Eren's use of the Araklos chain, to which her husband adds that there is a link between the chain and Eren's ancestors. Once she leaves, I talk to Elena, who doesn't understand why Mavda kept information from them. I respond to her anxiety by making a Dumar translating for me. I then buy a green garb from Mavda. I then get the Sword 9 upgrade using 2 Aegis Steel, 2 Crystal Ore, 2 Mercury, and a Fire Ore. She then gives me the Beast's Curse, an article about the theory of creatures from the Scar trading places with humans. I then give Elena the green garb. She says this is a common style of dress in Illyria. In the cellar, I find Divine Unification. It says that the creation of the original Masters took place in the Centrum, the 13th tower in the centre of the towers, starting with the creation of something called Zeron. Zeron was to be the catalyst to unite the 12 laws, but as we already know, that ended in failure. I also find a heroic race, an eyewitness account of the Vestra holding the land in place after the failed experiment, creating the Scar. There's also an unreadable old text I hand over to Elena. I'm given access to 2 more towers, Dawn Tower and Dusk Tower. I choose Dawn Tower. Everything's covered in this bright gold glow. It looks cool. We're back to a male god this time, but with wings symbolising light. There are doors in the back and the right. I go right first, but the stairs are blocked off and there's a purple glow I can't reach. So instead I go through the door in the back. The first enemy I kill drops my first lightshade shard. I climb up the wall to see another side of the room is blocked off, so I go in the door to the left. I go up the stairs and through the next door. There's another purple glow here and I step into it. This warps me into the Dusk Tower, the dark equivalent, and the rubble blocking me from going further isn't here. So as you've probably worked out, I need to warp between the two towers to solve both at the same time. This is really cool and makes them my favourite towers in the game. Dusk Tower has a bright purple glow everywhere that looks cooler though. I find the file Blacklight Vortexes. It talks about being able to warp between towers and how to open even more vortexes. There will be faint glows of yellow or purple in some spots, and these will require finding and using light stones and shade stones respectively on them to open them. I then go back through the door that led to this room, then down the stairs and through the door again. The rubble is gone here so I can reach the door on the other side. There's an unopened vortex here but I don't have a light stone yet. Here I can unlock a blue door leading back to the entrance of a Dusk Tower. I then return to the room I first warped here and walk over to the next vortex, returning to the Dawn Tower. In the first set of boxes I break, I find my first 3 light stones. I then go through the next door. In the corner of this room is Blacklight Controls. It repeats how the vortexes work to really hammer it in. There's a vortex in the other corner and a closed one reached by chaining up to this ladder. I don't have any shade stones, so I go through the one below. There's no way to get up to the next floor in the Dusk Tower. In the corner I found the file, I find my first shade stone. I then go back through the door to find another. I go back in the vortex, then climb up to the closed one and use a shade stone to open it. This is how I get higher. I can knock down a ladder so I don't have to mess about with that again, then unlock the sealed door and destroy the first of 8 chains, 4 for each tower. At the observatory, Elena is talking to a bird and pretending it's Eren. After last episode, I wouldn't trust a near one. I go through the door on the left. The stairs here are blocked by rubble, but there's a vortex back to the Dawn Tower. I go back through the door, lower another ladder, open the sealed door again, and destroy the Dawn Tower's first chain. Can't go any further from here, so I return to the Dusk Tower and go right, past the sealed door, and climbing up to the next floor. There's a chain leading up, but I can't deal with it for a bit, so I just go through the door. After taking out the 2 enemies with purple mist in this narrow space, I go through the next door and through a vortex. I get attacked by a new enemy, this floating knight thing. It doesn't get to try much before I kill it and reach level 37. The door across from the vortex is locked on the other side, so I go through the door up the stairs. Up here is a closed vortex, but a larger glow means it's open on this side. I need to open it on the dusk side. I don't realise this and waste both my shade stones. So I drop down, ignore the vortex here and go through the door. Here I can unlock that last door and there's a chain I follow through another door. I couldn't climb here in the dusk version of the room, but here I can lower a ladder and chain up to another sealed door so I can unlock it, pick up my first luminous stone inside and destroy the Dawn Tower's second chain. I then backtrack to the vortex I skipped and go in it. It gives me the chance to replace the shade stones I wasted. However, I get my first death. Ever, I think. I don't think I died once when I first played this 8 years ago. I'm checkpointed after breaking the second chain, so I didn't lose much. And it's harder when I get back. Last time, only one beast had purple mist. This time, both do. I can use the opposite tower's stone to stun them, though. I reach level 38, killing one of them. Once they're dead, I go through the door where I get my first Stygian stone. I go back and climb up the wall to find another red locked door and open the vortex I wasted those shade stones on. I cross the balcony that's missing in the Dawn Tower and go through the vortex at the other end. I then go through the door, up some stairs, and go through the next door. I go right and through the next door again. There's a sealed door I can't reach, so I open the vortex of a dust tower's version of this room. I unlock the door here and then climb up to the higher level to find black-like stones. It tells me about using the stones to stun enemies. As I approach the sealed door, I'm attacked by the dusk version of those night beasts. Once I kill it, I unlock the door and destroy the dusk tower's second chain. Going right from the door is another vortex back to the dawn tower. I then swing over to the sealed door and destroy the dawn tower's third chain, just three left between the two. I then return to the dusk tower and go through the door I unlocked. At the end of this room is another locked door, and I go through the one between it and the one I entered from. I go down the stairs, open the vortex here, but stick in the dusk tower and go through the door at the bottom. There's nothing here and I've been here long enough, I walk back. Did well though, five of the chains in the first visit. Since Elena transformed while wearing the green garb, I find it damaged on the table. On a desk I find Sounds in a Dream, I then give her some flesh. Mavta gives me a spirit silver for selling her over 500 liots worth of flesh. I repair the green garb and rest until Elena is awake. When I talk to her, I get a scene where Aaron eats the breakfast Elena made him. Apparently, it's not very good. I talk to her again and she gives me the free file she translated, Vessel Testament 10, Creating Zeron, and Alchemist Duty 5. She's also found out what the noises at night are about. She found a scratch on her bed frame. Turns out it was a mouse. I was expecting it to be her losing control. I give her back the green garb and she's apologetic for getting it dirty. She gives me an ambrosia for reaching level 3 affinity. She's a little late on that. I do lower the affinity though with a large bone just to make sure it stays low enough for the ending I want. Vessel Testament 10 is the story of a starving woman who spent years in jail after stealing some food, was released to find a war happened and made the world worse, so volunteered to be a vessel. Creating Zeron tells us that Zeron was the final experiment after the Masters, created using a married couple. You can probably guess who. After that it's back to the tower, this time I start in the Dusk Tower. I go in the room in the back but there's nowhere to climb in this tower's version, so it's backtracking to where I got up to last time. I go through the door I unlocked last time I was here and reach level 39. I open another vortex and go through the door leading to a ladder in the back room I can lower. I also get my first white droplet here. Then I start making my way back to where I got last time. I reach level 40 on the way, followed by level 41 seconds later. A lot of purple mist this time through. Only 9 levels off the cap now. So apparently there's a game breaking glitch in the US version of this game to do with these towers. I can't say much about it myself since it's not in this version. It is strange though since I thought the US version was just supposed to be a straight port of the European version, but I don't know anything about changing the game's region coding. I return to the room outside the one containing the third sealed door in the Dawn Tower and go through the door at the far left end. In this room you can see the other tower through a window. I open the vortex in the corner to reach the Dusk version and unlock the door. There's a vortex floating above the now broken bridge, but I don't think much of it yet. I then chain up to the ladder on the bridge and go through the door there. After killing the enemies I open the vortex and go back through the door to get on top of the bridge. I then lower a ladder next to the door on the other end, then go through it. I ignore the next set of enemies and just go through the next door. This leads to the Master's door just in time for my footage to corrupt. Of course I'm still missing 3 chains. I find the Blacklight Masters file here, looks like I'm in for 2 Masters at once. I also find an unreadable old note next to it and go through the vortex. I leap through the way I came and backtrack to the other side of the bridge to lower a ladder and pick up my first Dark Matter. I then return to the room with the Master's door and find another unreadable old note. I go back through the vortex and go through the door on the right, and then the one right of that. In here I find a third unreadable old note. I leave this room and here is where I get a bit confused. There are some points to swing across but nowhere to swing to. I can see the last chain going through this wall and the point to destroy it through a hole, but I can't get to it. So I go back into the Dusk Tower and go through the right door here, but the door on the right in this room is locked on the inside, and the sealed door is blocked by a wall of rubble. There is another floating vortex next to it though, so I leave and climb up the wall next to it. I can see a vortex next to a chest in the locked room. It hasn't clicked yet and I'm looking for another point to chain to get inside. But then it clicks. The other end of the vortex is invisible. So I go back to the room on the right in the Dawn Tower and use a stone in the corner to make a vortex appear, and then use those grapple points to swing to it. I unlock the door and unlock the sealed door to destroy the third Dusk Tower chain. I figure I've been in there long enough and warp out. I give them more stuff to translate and tell her to stop perving over Aaron's bulking up from all the exercise going on through the towers. I then give her some flesh. After selling my stuff to Mavda, I go back in. On the way back up, I reach level 42. I return to this room on the Dawn side where I found an unreadable note and use a shade stone in the corner to reveal the hidden vortex. I get a spirit silver from the chest along with a damaged orb of opposites and an unreadable grimy note. I unlock the door and find the file Centrum the Fulcrum. For whatever reason, the army were unable to get inside the 13th tower 50 years ago. At this point, the vortex above the hole finally clicks. I go back down to this bridge in the Dawn Tower and use a stone in the center. This drops me right in front of the sealed door. I unlock it, destroy the final chain for the Dusk Tower and return to the top. I also find an unreadable grimy note next to the hole. For the final chain, I go into the top chain room in the Dusk Tower and use a stone in the middle to create a vortex to the final Dawn Tower chain and destroy it. Now I can finally take on the Masters. I start with the Duskmaster and she's just stuck in the wall waiting for me to pull on her flesh, tearing her out of said wall. I don't get to do much before she traps me and waltz me back to the Dawn Tower's master door. He's also stuck in the wall, but this time pulling on his flesh destroys the wall completely, leaving me to face both at once. They both have barriers around their flesh and only the opposite element can weaken that barrier. I can walk in front of one master while the other is charging a laser and make them shoot the other. They both throw projectiles that I can pick up and throw at the other two. Another attack they have is firing out mini black holes. It takes 3 hits on one to fully remove their barrier. When I get rid of the Dawn Master's barrier, I just keep pulling on that flesh, ignoring most of the damage I'm taking. I get it to the last 1/5 of its health before he repairs his barrier. But I take it down not long after and finish him off, taking his flesh. He leaves some projectiles behind for dealing with the other. You don't want to defeat the first while the other has a lot of health though, because after a while, the survivor can revive the other. So you need to kill them close to each other. And that's everything to do with this fight. I finished them off a few minutes later and had the final 2 Master Flesh. When I get back to the observatory, Mavda is already waiting for me, surprised when I'm back with 2. Since Elena transformed, the white gold ring broke. I give her the last pieces of Master Flesh. She rips both of them from my hands and wolfs them down. For the last dream, we see the start of Experiment Zero on Ruben's mother. However, the experiment is failing, leading to an incomplete master. She also sees her husband holding a child, not knowing whose it is, believing he had a child with someone else. She says that her children's lives will be linked to his children's before demanding to know why this had to happen. As usual, Elena passes out. The next morning, Elena is missing from her bed. First I go to Mavda and sell my stuff, along with getting the white gold ring repaired. I go into the courtyard. So this final boss is a watered down version for this ending. One of her attacks has her use the flesh from one of the Metal Masters to make a series of stalagmites rush out towards me. To damage her, I have to pull on the flesh that appears as she does these attacks. She'll try to uppercut me and use the flesh from a Fire Master to shoot fireballs at me. These are the only 2 flesh she'll use for the ending C final boss. I must say, I always like it when games have enemies or bosses invade areas that have always been seen as safe. It just feels wrong in a good way. Each flesh has its own life bar and when it's destroyed, the boss can no longer use that attack. I finish her off soon after.
No. No. No, 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 this cannot be!
Elena.
Aaron. This is it.
Hold the towers together with Elena's powers. We could bring this war to an end. But a wiser course would be to take this chance. To unite the whole land under the flag of Illyria. After all, the towers were for the military's exclusive use.
Aaron, you're the only one who can do it. You can command our forces and influence Elena.
In the year 511 of the Unified Era, the Kingdom of Illyria lost patience with Athos, who refused to accept their conditions for a peace treaty. An army division headed by Elena was formed, made up of the servant beasts that dwelled within the towers. Spearheaded by this force, Illyria invaded Athos. Within a short time, the capital of Athos fell. The kingdom of Illyria united Imperia under its flag. Old rulers were deposed, and the Illyrian era was ushered in.
Well, wasn't that miserable? That was ending C, still together. We're not done yet though, I've just unlocked New Game Plus and I'm only at 74%. That last 26 will be next episode. We're back to Pandora's Tower one last time to get those last three endings and clear up some other ends to finally reach 100%. Last time I got the C ending, where Elena transformed into a master and her and Eren got enslaved by a Valyrian army and used to conquer Eren's home country. Not the happiest of events, but there's three more endings to get. When loading a cleared save, I can choose which part of the game to start from. Since I need to go through every tower again anyway, I choose to start from the beginning and go through the tutorial stuff again. The very first thing I do after moving into this house of Elena is shove all that unreadable stuff from the end of the last playthrough in her hands for her to translate. I can also have a talking about the flowers she planted in the future, that have now bloomed after only their first night here. Mavda now has items that can only be bought on a New Game Plus. Most important is the Crimson Key. Remember the last two episodes when I wouldn't shut up about all those red doors I couldn't open? This is what this key is for. There are new gifts for Elena too. I buy a tactical manual for myself because I'm so close to the next level, along with a rustic painting for Elena. Giving it to Elena gets you a little cutscene where they hang it up. I have always liked the little collectibles that you actually get to see around your house in games. After this, I give her the certain carpet Mavda gave me all the way back during Ironclad Turret in episode 10, followed by the music box she gave me during Crimson Keep. The box plays Niosian hymns, so she loves it. I then return the white gold ring that she broke last playthrough. Unlike the flower seeds, she doesn't remember me giving her this in the future. I also give her a quality metal I've had for ages so she can expand my bag one more time for 60 item slots. For giving her so many presents, she gives me a Sage Stone. Time to tackle Treetop Tower again and get our new stuff with that key. With all the levels and weapon upgrades I've had since the first time I went through this, you can expect I'm tearing through everything in my way with no trouble. First locked door is found by taking the optional second lift in the back room up to the top. There are actually two up here, so I go through the one on the right first. This just has some enemies and consumable items to pick up. I then try the door at the back, which just gets me a gleaming amber. The next one is found just progressing through the tower normally. It leads to a room that leads to another containing a chest that gets me a Sage Stone. I also finally remember to use that tactical manual to get myself to level 43. This room also has two more doors. The one in the centre leads to more items, while the one in the back leads to a hole that finally lets me open that chest back on the first floor for a panacea. On my very first playthrough 8 years ago, I replayed Treetop Tower so many times trying to figure out how to reach this chest that was just in view. Imagine the disappointment when it turned out to just be a healing item. And that's it for Treetop Tower. Though having three more doors to unlock, the rewards were a letdown. Also, a fully charged chain yank wipes out the master in one. After giving Elena the master flesh, I buy a lamp from Mavda. I also get the Twin Blade 8 upgrade using a gleaming amber, an Aegis steel, a phoenix stone and some mercury. Remember the Twin Blade, now you've only got about half a second's use. Good times. Elena gives me the translated Vessel Testament 11, Vessel Testament 12 and Alchemist Dewey 7. I then give her the lamp, having forgotten that she already got one last episode and I've just wasted nearly 2 grand. It's right there on the table and I still missed it. The two testaments reveal that the Dawn and Duskmasters were twins orphaned in the war and separated. They both volunteered to become vessels at the same time, presumably never finding out until it was too late. These three files more than cover the money I wasted on that lamp. I buy a bronze mirror and give it to Elena. She likes it, but understandably hasn't felt like looking in a mirror much lately. New stuff in the cellar, the file Rise of the Army. The story of an observer to the crowning of a 10-year-old king chosen by the army. He gets to see the excessive feasting in the army and previous king supporters trying to outdo each other in their excess. Or while outside the capital, everyone else is starving and suffering thanks to the wars. Time to revisit Shia Drop Spire. There's a door to unlock just to the left of the statue right as I enter the tower. It gets me a diamond and not much else. The next one can be found in the first outdoor area where you're introduced to the ore mechanic. This one actually gets me something, a chest containing the most powerful weapon in the game, the explosive stake. Right now it's weaker than my scythe, but that has 8 upgrades in it. One thing to point out is that while my inventory and character and relationship progress carry over, tower progress does not. So chains have to be destroyed again and ladders need to be lowered again. No, just using the shortcuts from the beginning to make things easier. In the room with the ore beasts, I find an unreadable old note I missed the first time through. That's it for Shia Drop Spire though, and once again the master's entire health bar is wiped out in one. Only one reward, but it's the most useful one of them all. When I get back, Elena gives me the translator to Alchemy Teachings 5 and Alchemist Duty 6, before I give a mod to translate, followed by the Master Flesh. I only said it once 2 episodes ago, so I should bring it up again. I don't cover what's in the alchemy files because they are simply hints on finding items and forging, they contain no story content. From Mavda, I buy an ancient clock. I then get the stake 2 upgrade using 2 gunpowder, an abyss ingot, some mercury, and 2 oil. Then stake 8 with an aegis steel, a shadow ore, 5 gunpowder, and a blast stone. I then forge a lump of metal so I can use it with some gunpowder, a crystal ore, and some mercury for stake 1, which gets Meek's next charge attack. I then forge another blast stone so I can use 2 of them with 2 spirit silver and some mercury for stake 9. This puts it just above the scythe with only half the amount of upgrades, so I permanently move over to the stake. I then give Elena the ancient clock, which gets us a cutscene there in putting the clock up while Elena admires it.
Whenever I can't get to sleep, I just stare at the clock's pendulum for a while.
It's been up 2 seconds, you fucking liar! After resting an hour, I talk to her while she's outside to get a scene where they admire the now blossom flowers. Elena also teases Aaron for staring at her too much. Apparently pinching his nose pissed him off. In the cellar is the file War of Independence. It started when Athos, Surtees and Thena wanted to be their own entities outside of Illyrian rule. It didn't really work out as I'd hoped. I then buy some more flower seeds from Mavda and give them to Elena. Now to redo Wellspring Steeple. The stake has much less range than the scythe, but it more than makes up for it with the strength. Plus it's killing everything in one hit right now anyway. There's a locked door in the corridor that leads to the first chain. It contains utter donkey dick. There's also a chest with a sage stone I missed the first time. The other locked door is in the room with the giant current. This shows the power of the stake when its second charge attack just wipes out a beast with purple mist. I get an unreadable old note in a chest and a tactical manual from one of the bookshelves. I could easily go and deal with the master quickly, but I need Elena to not transform, so I warp out. On the shelf at the stairs is Enemy Kingdoms 1. It just gives some general info on Athos. It's in the north, even though it's Elena who has the slight northern accent, because her actress is northern. I then give Elena the note for translating and some flesh. I then buy a glass vase from Mavda, which I give to Elena the next morning. I get another cutscene where she admires it before it goes on the table. Having affinity at level 3 or higher, I also get another cutscene about Elena cooking for Aaron. She still doesn't have the hang of it and I still can't praise it. Then with Mavda, I create an amber bracelet using a gleaming amber and a lump of metal. It goes straight to Elena. Time to finish off Wellspring Steeple. Yet another all health in one. For giving Elena between 1 and 4 Master Flesh at affinity level 3, we get a scene where she invites Aaron up to the roof with her. Aaron just stares at her while she does some stretches. After that, she points out the direction her village is in and thanks Aaron for the 1000th time. Next, I'm back off to Crimson Keep. First door I find is at the room in the back of the entrance where I lower the ladders to. Among the items on the floor is another tactical manual, which is good since at this point my level progress is incredibly slow. In the chest is an apron. When I return home, I find no challenge observed at the stairs, which is a little insight into Elena's cooking journey. Elena also gives me Alchemy Teachings 1 when I talk to her. After giving her some flesh, I quickly click on all the tutorial files just to get them faded out. It would have bothered me if I did everything in the game but left them lit up. When she wakes up, I give her the apron. This just puts the affinity up to level 4 too, for which she gives me a sage stone. I then buy another red drape and go back to Elena. For giving her between 3 and 6 Master Flesh and having her affinity at least level 4 without letting her transform once, I get a cutscene where she holds onto Aaron's arm and makes him a little uncomfortable. I then give her the red drape. Since she already used one for a bedsheet, she uses it for a red tablecloth instead. Then it's back in Crimson Keep. There was only the one locked door in this tower, so it's straight to the boss. For the first time, I don't take all health in one, just 3/4 of its health. The rest of it goes quick enough though. After giving the Master Flesh to Elena, in the cellar I find the file Experiment Success. The Illyrian army managed to artificially recreate the power of the Araklos chain for their experiments. Ironclad turret next. During it, I get another tactical manual that takes me up to level 44. One locked door here is found just before reaching the top, but I don't have time to fully explore it. When returning from my first visit, I find a magic formula near Elena's desk. It's a recipe for pancakes. Elena also gives me the Alchemy Teachings 4 she translated. With Mavda, I get the upgrade stake 3 using 3 gunpowder, an explosive ore, some mercury, and 2 oil. I follow it up with stake 10 using 2 dark matter, an orb of opposites, 8 loops of metal, and a stygian stone. This gets a stake's 3rd charge attack. Then it's back in. That locked door leads to another door to a room that just has a couple items. The second and last locked door is found to the right of the door to the master. The room has a chest containing an unreadable old note. Then it's just taking out the master again. Before I give Elena the flesh, I give her that note to translate. Afterwards, I buy a certain tome from Mavda. I then get the stake 7 upgrade using 2 aegis steel, 2 abyss ingots, a steel ingot, and a phoenix stone. I give Elena the certain tome. It has many stories that she used to read to her younger brothers, so she's grateful for the nostalgia trip. A little later I bring affinity up to level 5 by talking to her a lot. She gives me a guard stone for it. After that I move on to the Arcadian Tower. Another tactical manual pulled off a wall for another experience boost. The first locked door is in the first room you meet the moths. Through the door is a chest containing a formal dress. The next one is just on the normal path along the second floor, you can't miss it. However, there's nothing here, just a hole that leads back to the room with the dress I was just in. For returning home without Master Flesh between 7 a.m. and 5 p.m. with 4 to 6 towers completed, I get another scene where Aaron comes home to Elena singing outside. He just sits down and watches. After giving her some flesh, I find the file after unification upstairs. It simply contains a timeline of the new Illyrian king being crowned, followed by the reconstruction of the towers and development of the masters, followed by the War of Independence. Once Elena wakes up, I give her the formal dress and get back to the Arcadian Tower. No more doors to unlock, so it's just plowing through the tower as normal and taking out the master. After Elena is awake after eating the Master Flesh, I get another cutscene where she gives Aaron a present. For this one, you have to have given 6 Master Flesh and at least 50 presents. She made him Elena's amulet, which gives a boost to all stats when equipped. After once again lowering Elena's affinity so there's no danger of getting the wrong ending, I go into the cellar and find enemy kingdoms too. This one is about Surtees, which never got along with Valyria because they only worship the one god. We've heard of this place before with the certain tome I gave Elena, but they aren't very important to the story. It also talks about Fina. It exists. After that, it's off to Rockshard Rampart. The first door found just has some items. The second in this later outdoor area leads to a ladder I can knock down to create another shortcut back in the first outdoor area. The third floor, found in one of the rooms I meet a Minotaur, has a chest containing an unreadable grimy note. I give it to Elena for translating. Up the stairs is more of Elena's cooking adventures with no benefits. From Mavda, I buy a night storybook. When Elena's awake, she gives me the alchemy teachings free she translated. I then give her the book, which turns out to be a story her mother read to her when she was a child. Then back to Rockshard Rampart and finishing it off. In Torrent Peak, the first locked door is on the third floor. I find an unreadable grimy note and a tactical manual that gets me to level 45. First time I head back, Elena gives me Alchemist Duty 2 and I give her the grimy note to translate. Next to her desk is the file Holy Scripture, and in the cellar is another unreadable old note which I give to Elena when she's awake. I then take out the Torrent Master again. At this point, the masters are taking around as long as they did the first time through. Blazing Citadel next. First door is on the second floor of the Dark Room. It leads to a balcony with an unreadable grimy note. When I go back to give it to Elena, she gives me the Uniting the Realms file she translated. For giving Mavda at least 150 liots of flesh from Blazing Citadel, she gives me a red rug. Uniting the Realm is written from the point of view of someone in the Illyrian army close to the end of the war. Upstairs I find the file Before Unification. It's another timeline on the creation of the original masters. By Elena's desk is Future Plans. Of note is that Elena would like a mother to live with them when they had their own place. Her dad and brothers can fuck off, I guess. Why does Mavda want to buy Elena's scribblings about her ideal future anyway? What's she gonna do with that information? I then give Elena the red rug when she's awake. Then it's back to Blazing Citadel. Next door is above the entrance to the furnace. It has a chest with a noble garb inside. Next time I return, Elena has translated Alchemist Duty 3 for me. I also give her the noble garb. Then it's my third visit to Blazing Citadel and finishing off the master again. After giving Elena the flesh, I get the upgrade Stake 4 using 2 Abyss Ingots, 5 lumps of metal, a crystal ore, and some mercury. Now for True Gold Tower. First visit has nothing new to point out. On my return, next to Elena's desk is Curious Text, which has a few assorted bits in it, like a chapter on love potions. Elena also translated Alchemist Duty 4 for me. There's another unreadable old text in the cellar that I give to Elena right away. After returning from my second visit, Elena translated About the Testaments for me. I forget to read it and head off back to the tower. For whatever reason, True Gold Tower is the only one lacking a locked door, so I just head up and kill the master again. After this, Mavda gives me the file Bless This Couple. It's written by Mavda honouring Aaron and Elena. Nice gesture after selling them out to the Illyrian army in the previous ending. Now for the Dawn and Dusk Towers. First door is found dropping down here in the Dawn side. It has a couple items and a vortex of the Dusk side which just has more items. When I return, next to Elena's desk is her ideal family with Aaron in A Family to Be. The final locked door you can't miss, you have to pass it going through the tower, and once again it's just more items. It wasn't the idea, but the stake was the only worthwhile reward across all 12 towers. I also reached level 46 a couple minutes later, while the footage corrupted from me compressing the video file. Now I'm not compressing any video files until I've actually made the episode it's going to be used in. There was also one vortex I missed last time here leading to the final chest in the game. It's another Sage Stone. On my next go through the tower, I reach level 47. I also make it to the end and kill the masters again. I then give Elena the final piece of Master Flesh. Once again, Elena is missing after Aaron wakes up. But instead of the courtyard, she's on the roof.
Elena. Elena.
I'm sorry.
The curse, has it not been lifted?
When I go back inside, Mavda is waiting, saying she'll accompany Eren to the towers. Now I have the option for the 13th tower, Centrum, mentioned in various files last episode. He starts me off in the boss arena of the Dawn and Dusk Towers, but now I can go through the doors I couldn't before. This leads to many stairs, passing a statue of a god or goddess depending on the door I chose. Halfway up, Eren can hear Elena singing. Even more stairs later, I find some old wood on the floor beneath a huge bell. Past it is even more stairs until I reach the top.
Eren.
Elena!
I felt quite at home in her body. But it is time to carry out my plan.
Who are you?
You may call me Zeron. Well, that's who I was at the end.
That's right.
But I was never completed.
Where is she?
I put her to sleep. I thought she would put up a fight. But in the end, it was simple.
Give her back.
No!
Thanks to your sterling work gathering all 12 masters, I am able to move freely. Though I am still very much a work in progress. In any case, what use would you have with a girl like that? How could you have coped? Things have worked out for the best, wouldn't you say?
Elena, give her back! My Elena, give her back!
True final boss time. Last time was just a teaser. Any ending above C gives you the full fight. It also gives you some context behind her, revealing her to be the Zeron mentioned in a lot of files last time. Before she'd just used the powers of the fire and metal masters, but now she can use all the elements. She first starts by making bolts of lightning crash down at me. She can use the water element to create a razor sharp water disc with her hand and try slashing me. It lingers on the ground to give you the chance to damage the flesh. The wood element has her create a wave of roots and send them at me. The earth element has her create rocks on the ground that burst to send shards all over. This is the easiest one to deal with. She still has a grab that will result in Eren being spiked into the ground if she can grab him. If you let the roots from her wood attack grab you, you'll also be spiked into the ground. And that water attack should be simple to avoid, but I get hit nearly every single time. The wood flesh is the first to be destroyed. When her flesh is destroyed, she tries a lightning attack again. This reveals all remaining flesh and gives you the chance to damage any of them, providing you don't get hit. This is followed very closely by me destroying the water flesh. With two flesh gone, she started using the fire and metal attacks from last time again. The earth flesh goes next. With three gone, she starts using the power of light and dark masters by first creating a dark vortex that drags me in, and then following up with a beam of light. Soon after, I destroy the fire and metal flesh, leaving just the combined light and dark one. For all this fight, the final boss theme has been an arrangement of the same song Elena has been singing all game. But this version has three distinct voices in it. There's the male and female choirs from the Master Boss themes, and they're both overpowering Elena's voice. However, with every flesh you destroy, Elena's voice gets slightly louder until you reach this point where her voice is the dominant one. All that's left at this point is that last flash, so now I'm just trying to outdamage Zeron. I have plenty of healing items, so I don't even bother dodging, so I can get as many hits in as possible until she's defeated.
Elena! Elena!
Oh, Aaron. She is still within me. Zeron. She is a sad soul who ended up alone. As long as she dwells here within me, it can only cause you hardship. Thank you for everything. Now, Mavda, if you please.
I'll be taking this. It is time for the scar to heal.
I will take Zeron with me. I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Elena.
I'm sorry. I had to make this choice without you.
In the year 511 of the Unified Era, the vast valley known as the Scar ceased to disfigure Imperia, and with it, the curse infecting the land also vanished from the earth.
Well, that was only slightly less depressing. That was ending B, all for you. Aaron still failed to free Elena from the curse, and this time she dies. But at least she isn't enslaved as a living weapon to destroy Aaron's home country with, I guess. And Mavda doesn't sell them out this time.
Elena, what more could I have done for you?
Higher affinity, mate. This one you get for affinity between levels 4 to 6. Now when I start the game up, Aaron is on the title screen alone. That playthrough got me up to 87%, still two endings to go. This time I choose to start with all but the final two towers completed. I first give Elena the old wood I found in the Centrum. Elena figures out what it is, but doesn't say. First thing I do is spend a lot of time in Treetop Tower. I want money for some of the gifts I still haven't bought yet, so I'm farming flesh. On giving Elena some flesh on my return, I get her up to affinity level 7. I genuinely don't know where I got to 6. I kept an eye on every bit of forage outside the towers and I still missed it. The reward for level 6 is a power stone, by the way. Giving Mavda a minimum of 600 liots of flesh from Treetop Tower gets me a shield talisman. All the towers have free rewards, and while I don't think they count towards 100%, they are one time across all playthroughs like the chests, so I have to get them all. Of course, a good chunk of the money I made goes towards repairing all the items Zeron busted up. After talking to Elena again, the reward for reaching Affinity 7 is a sacred talisman. After resting a couple hours, I get another cutscene about Elena's cooking. This time she has confidence she did it right. The options when she asks how it was aren't much better than last time though. Next I go back to Sheer Drop Spire to farm. 800 liots of flesh from there got me a bronze mirror. I didn't need to spend the money buying one for Elena, I could've just got this one for free. I still give it to her for the affinity. I decide to stall on the flesh rewards for now and just go for an extending, so I go for the Dawn and Dusk Towers again. On my first return home, I buy one more set of flower seeds from Mavda. I also forge my first black droplet. There's still some items used to forging I hadn't found one of yet. I then forge quite a few more materials and get the Stake 5 upgrade using 3 Abyss Ingots and a Phoenix Stone. I follow this up with Scythe 10 using a Dark Matter, an Orb of Opposite, some Sacred Ashes and 5 Black Droplets. Then it's Twin Blades 10 using a Spirit Silver, an Orb of Opposite, 4 White Droplets and 3 Luminous Stones. I then give a lane of the Flower Seeds. Nothing of note happens from then to me defeating the Blacklight Masters for the third time. As before, a lane eats the flesh, ends up on the roof, is taken over by Zeron and I have to walk up the Centrum again. I should also point out that the Old Wood isn't there on subsequent playthroughs, it's one of the kind. The cutscene is different when we reach the top.
Darling, at last we can be together.
No! Don't get any closer to Aaron!
Oh, the 12 masters have been gathered. Aaron, I am here. I am here so we can be united once more.
What do you mean to do with Aaron?
Can't you keep your mouth shut? It's you who kept me waiting for 50 years after the scar opened.
50 years ago? The cataclysm. It was you who caused it. So it was Experiment Zero. It was you that caused the scar to open.
That's right. Humans started a foolish, wasteful war half a century ago. To win that war, they went as far as developing living, breathing weapons. The terrible errors of 500 years before were repeated. The 13 of us. Oh. Couldn't stand to see any more senseless sacrifice. By becoming one with Aaron, my wish from 5 centuries ago will finally be granted. To bring peace to the world. If we don't go through with this, mankind will never know peace again!
So yeah, if the files combined with Elena's dreams last episode and the voice actress didn't do it, the game confirms now that Zeron is Reuben's mother after the failed Experiment Zero. It also explains what the Old Wood was. It's Reuben's toy horse, worn away after 500 years. Fighting against Zeron is the same, so we can skip over that.
Aaron!
Elena! Elena! Elena!
Five hundred years ago, Zeron sacrificed herself in order to build a peaceful world for the future. But Experiment Zero ended in failure.
What?
I don't know why, but I feel her fierce desire for you. Burning deep down within me still. I must warn you that someday I am bound to do you harm. Oh. Aaron, farewell. Experiment Zero must end now.
Elena, I can't let you do this alone.
Thank you for loving me, no matter what.
If only I could have done more.
Aaron?
Let us go. We will always be together. I can't imagine a world without you. You are everything to me, and I mean that.
you beside me, the scar will surely heal.
In the year 511 of the Unified Era, the vast valley known as the Scar ceased to disfigure Imperia, and with it, the curse that had infected the land vanished. The names of Aeron and Elena were forgotten and lost to the past. But the tribe of the Vestra told future generations of two heroes who saved the world from an unimaginable fate. And yet, turmoil still prevails. Along the border of Illyria, disputes flare up without cease. There is still a long road to travel before mankind truly knows peace.
Okay, not any happier. That was ending A, Together Forever, for having Affinity be around levels 6 to 8.
We said we'd always be together, didn't we?
Now the title screen has both Aeron and Elena. This brought me up to 90%, just one more ending to get. This time I choose to start off with the first 5 towers completed, since there are still some cutscenes I need to get in the second half of the game. First thing I do is go to Wellspring Steeple for some farming. At least 500 liots of flesh from that tower gets me a certain tome. Another gift I didn't need to spend the money on. Of course, I still give Wrath of the point. It also gets me to Affinity level 8, which has to give me a bulwark band. In the evening, forgiving Elena between 5 and 9 Master Flesh on a new game plus and having Affinity at least level 5, I get another cutscene of the two watching the sunset on the roof. Aeron even lets himself pull her in for a cuddle. After that, it's time to farm Crimson Keep. However, I'd forgotten I'd already got the rewards to Crimson Keep back in my first playthrough. To be fair, there were about 2 months between recording my first visit to Crimson Keep and recording this part. I buy some more flower seeds and give them to Elena. She tells me she can't sow any more seeds after these. Then it's off to farm Ironclad Turret. 500 liots of flesh from it gets me a glass vase. So many gifts I spent money on that I could have got for free. Now to go through Arcadian Tower yet again and hope I can farm the required amount of flesh at the same time. I don't get it done in one, but when I return, Elena is waiting for me. I get another cutscene where Elena shows off all the flowers she's grown with the seeds I got her. She also somehow planted a carrot.
Did you see all the flowers?
It's been 2 seconds. We're still standing in them. I only got 550 liots of flesh, so I got a white rug and pure band. I need to give her 1,000 liots worth for the best reward. The rug is new though, so I give it to Elena. I take out the Arcadian Master again in my next visit. Giving the Master Flesh to Elena just brings the Affinity up to level 9. I have just another 1,000 liots worth of flesh from Avda, which gets me an Ancient Clock. I really didn't need to spend any money on Elena, did I? The reward for level 9 Affinity is a strong armband. After resting, I get another cutscene with Elena. If she's in between 6 and 9 Master Flesh, not transformed, and has Affinity at least level 8, she'll hug Aeron from behind. She doesn't try snapping his neck this time. Would have been a fitting final seed to get, but I'm still missing a couple. Farming in Rockshard Rampart next. At least another 1,000 liots worth got me an Arcana Stone and another Night Storybook. Rockshard Master is killed again. The points of giving Elena its flesh raise Affinity to 10, the maximum level. She gives me a Spur Band for this. All these bands and accessories are never used. I've had the Farsight Band, Shield Talisman, Elena's Amulet and Skill Band equipped since I got them and used the rest of my inventory space on stones. But this time I swapped some stones out for the Spur Band since the stat boost from the band outdo the stones. Torrent Peak once again. 600 gets me an Ios pendant. After resting, I get the final Elena cooking scene. She's finally got it down. Aeron wolfs it down and every feedback choice is positive. I then give her the Ios pendant, which gets the final Elena scene where she admires it and Aeron helps her put it on. Torrent Master dead again. At this point, I've been at 99% files for ages, so I look at where the last one is. I missed the Crimson the Tiger file in Crimson Keep's Furnace. Now I have every file in the game. Now a time to revisit Blazing Citadel. The Master dies again and 600 liots of flesh gets me a Phoenix Stone and another formal dress. Now, for whatever reason, I have missing footage. My previous recording ended in the house, but this one begins in the middle of True Gold Tower. Luckily, I didn't miss anything. 800 gets me another rustic painting and another noble guard. I also buy more of the drapes so I can get all their second options. Bed cover for the blue drape, tablecloth for the cat's eye drape, and bed cover for the tangled drape. Then I kill the True Gold Master again. I can't just go and finish the Blacklight Towers right away since I still have more things to do, but I can at least get progress done and get the flesh rewards. During my first revisit, I reached level 48. Mavda gets 1,590 liots of flesh from me, which gets me an Orb of Opposites and a Promise Ring. That's all the flesh rewards obtained, and they save the best deal for last. The Promise Ring would cost 9,000 liots normally. I give it to Elena. That's the final present for Elena. Now all that's left is upgrading the weapons and gaining the last two levels. After a run through Blazing Citadel, I have another item type I either picked up, Explosive Powder. Two of these with an Aegis Steel and two lumps of metal get me the Sword 8 upgrade. Some forging, and a run through Ironclad Turret later, I get Stake 6 using 3 Abyss Ingots, 2 Explosive Powder and 2 Gunpowder. That's a stake fully upgraded and its final charge attack unlocked. A couple runs through Ironclad Turret and Blazing Citadel, plus some more forging, and I can get Sword 10 using a Spirit of Silver, an Orb of Opposites, 2 Aegis Steel and 2 White Droplets. That's the sword done. About 15 minutes later and a couple runs through Blazing Citadel and Crimson Keep, I can finish off the Twin Blades with Twin Blades 9 using 2 Gleaming Amber, a Steel Ingot, some Mercury and a Dawn Chorus. Just Scythe 9 now, for which I need to get a Shadow Ore and another item I haven't found yet. Shadow Ore are found in Rockshard Rampart, and the last item is a Permafrost, which I've been able to forge for ages. That with 2 Arcana Stones and a Bodily Fluid to finish off the Scythe for me. That's all weapons fully upgraded, now to reach level 50. I start by buying a Tactical Manual and using it. Through pure luck, a minute later I end up pulling another from a beast with Purple Mist. Using that one boosts me to level 49. And then I finally reach level 50 just roaming around the Blacklight Towers. All that's left now is to get that final ending. First off, I forge Chaos Robe for extra defence. With the extra equipment space from my levels and no longer needing the skill band due to being max level, I can now make room for it. You know how it goes from now, kill Blacklight Masters, feed Elena, yoink, climb up Centrum.
You are here! 5 centuries have passed! And now, finally, we can be together!
Aaron, no! Get away!
I came here so we could be together!
Could this be her? Could this be Experiment Zero?
That's right. But why so cold? We've been together since the Harvest Festival, haven't we?
So the dreams Elena saw when she ate Master Flesh, those were your memories?
No! Get out from inside me!
What is this girl sniveling about? Aaron did it all for me. He brought back that Master Flesh so I could regain my full power. Now I will be together with Aaron and we will become complete. Oh, Aaron! You look just like him, you know.
So, you are...
Stop! Get away from Aaron!
Elena!
Aaron? Zeren. She wants something from you. She wants part of your chain. She wants the part taken from her. 5 centuries ago.
Oh.
On that day, 5 centuries ago, the man who was meant to join her, to become a master alongside her, was your ancestor. The only reason she went after you is because of the bloodline you shared with the man she loved and lost that day.
So, the reason you were cursed, the reason she entered your soul, was that you were close to Aaron?
No, that's not it! It's because I loved Aaron. It's because I loved you.
Okay.
The mark has come from your back. Your skin is pure and untainted. The curse has been lifted.
Can it be true?
Well, if the curse is no more, our work here is done.
Aaron.
Let's go.
One last bit of gameplay, running from Zaran. She can grab you and try to eat you if she gets close, so you just have to wiggle the control stick to free yourself. She also squirts the purple ooze at you, but you can't actually die here, you just have to keep running until... Elena.
Aaron.
Now that the Oracle's chain has regained its power, Experiment Zero can be brought to an end. And the scar closed forever. The truth is, my people, the Vestra, played our part in causing this calamity. 500 years ago, my people worked for the cause of peace. We helped create the Masters. But then, when Experiment Zero failed, it spawned a series of tragedies.
I see.
Those 13 people who offered themselves up to serve as vessels, their sadness, their fury, their pain, their anguish, it haunts our people to this day.
Can it be true?
Now, listen to me. You have no more business here. You should be on your way. Go back to your world. A world that is now at peace. Experiment Zero. The 12 Masters. We are sorry for what we did to you. We know what we must do. So, old friend, our final task. must wield the Oracle's chain. We must make use of its power, as we did 5 centuries before. And again 5 decades ago. Lend us your power. Departed ancestors never once gave up hope. With each new generation born, our future, our hope lived on, the hope that this day would come. Let us now join them.
In the year 511 of the Unified Era, the vast valley known as the Scar vanished from the land of Imperia, and the 13 towers were destroyed. Mavda wrote a letter to the King of Illyria. This spurred the monarch to make a full and frank confession of the army's research into biological weapons in the 13 towers, and how this had triggered the cataclysm that created the Scar. No one knew the whereabouts of Mavda and her husband, but Mavda's tribe, the Vestra, were granted territory by the king. Here they set about building a country of their own once more. For the first time in 5 centuries, Imperia boasted 10 nations. With the disappearance of the Scar, Athos sued for peace with Illyria. As the war drew to a close, so each nation's army was reduced in scale. For the first time in half a century, peace prevailed across Imperia. With the end of hostilities, the army also called off its hunt for Aeron and Elena. The couple went to Elena's village and took over her family's trade. The Kingdom of Illyria sent a team to investigate the 13 towers, but all they found was a section of the chain that had supported them. The Scar was gone, as were the towers and the beasts within them. Gone too was the baleful curse which had plagued the land. The team did make one discovery. Aeron was indeed the descendant of the woman used in Experiment Zero. The bloodline of her and her husband could be traced directly to him, explaining her fierce desire to be united with him. The team tracked down Aeron and Elena to inform them of this fact. 5 centuries before, on that fateful day, a husband and wife were to serve as vessels to unite the 12 laws. This couple were to be used in Experiment Zero.
It's Experiment Zero. The subject is pregnant.
What did you say?
Call it off now. Hurry, it may not be too late.
What's the meaning of this?
Husband? He's fine. But how about his wife?
It's too late. Experiment Zero, it's already begun.
Ah, you failed!
Be silent! We must focus on saving the child. with the power of this chain.
Where have you gone?
It's about your wife. I'm afraid she didn't make it.
But
in all likelihood, your wife was unaware that she was pregnant. Right until the very end.
You're gone. You're gone. But he looks so much like Reuben. Our child is every bit as beautiful as Reuben was.
Our future is secure.
After the credits, so we can see my 100%, and after getting this ending, Elena's singing can be heard on the title screen. And that's Pandora's Tower. When I first played this game, this was the only ending I got, ending S, Unbreakable Bond, and it explained things well enough. But playing through it again 8 years later and working my way through the endings, I like that they each build on what they outright tell you about Xeron, starting with ending C telling you nothing and ending S filling in all the blanks. I enjoyed this game quite a lot, despite the simple and sometimes repetitive combat. I like the atmosphere of the towers and everything that's been going on behind the scenes while you think you're just trying to break that curse. Eren's kinda bland, but I did find Elena likeable. It's not the kind of game I could play repeatedly, but I could see myself coming back in a few years' time. I would really recommend giving this game a try.